studios this week, the Renegade Singles Competition, as well as BK Wall Street. We'll also see Hacksaw Jim Duggan in action, and the big, powerful man, Scott Flash Norton, the big main event one-on-one, the Pitbull Craig Pittman, along with Kenny Long, against the Horseman's Chris Benoit the Crippler, all next on Worldwide.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall, introducing first, from parts unknown, the Renegade!
Along with Bobby the Brain Heenan, this is Tony Schiavone. Welcome to WCW Worldwide Wrestling as we head into the month of September, as we head into WCW's Fall Brawl pay-per-view spectacular featuring War Games. Brain, what an electrifying youngster we have right here, the Renegade.
Well, I think his scarf's on too tight. That's what makes him act like he does. His head's tight.
His opponent from Reno, Nevada, the Gambler.
You think that's why he shakes his head?
Who knows why he shakes his head?
This gambler needs to be playing with another deck, I can tell you there.
Are you saying the deck he's playing with isn't full?
Those are big cards. I haven't seen cards that big in a long time.
The big hands. It's a big game. Big money's involved.
And we got a big program this week, including, as you heard a moments ago, the Pitbull Craig Pittman against the Crippler Chris Benoit, and the Renegade, a powerful man, and the Gambler. Well, the Gambler hits him right in the face with the cards. To start things off, the Gambler goes down hard. Andre takedown once again. Oh, the Gambler reeling after trying to get an early start against the Renegade.
Watch the Renegade's head. You know, the other night he went to an all-night diner, cost him $800 for coffee. They kept saying, you want another cup? And his head kept going up and down, up and down, up and down. Watch him, how many times his head goes yes and no. The man's nuts.
He certainly is one of the more effective athletes in WCW. The former world television champion, the Renegade. There's a right hand to the side of the head of the Gambler. Chasing the Gambler. The Gambler with a back elbow. And he blocked it that time. And now it's the Gambler whose head hits the apron here.
Now watch. He'll get his head moving. He gets himself going. He gets himself all motivated. He gets himself a nice arm drag on the Gambler.
He's showing a lot of quickness. There's no denying the Renegade has a tremendous amount of power. But now we're seeing a lot of quickness from the Renegade as well being displayed.
We certainly are, Mr. Schiavone.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as you know, and as we've been talking about, Fall Brawl is the pay-per-view spectacular we're all waiting for. It will be, as announced not too long ago on an edition of WCW Monday Nitro, the members of the Four Horsemen, Ric Flair and Arne Anderson, teaming with Lex Luger and Sting against the members of the New World Order. And, Brain, as you know, Fall Brawl means War Games, the match beyond two rings and closed in a cage. It is truly the single most dangerous match in the history of our sport.
You know, anytime you put this many volatile wrestlers in a ring, let alone two rings, let alone inside of a cage, let alone with WCW versus the New World Order, Hogan's turned his back on everyone. There's so much hatred here. You know, there's been grudges in this sport a long time. There's been people that don't really like you. There's been people that Killer Kowalski tore off Yukon Eric's ear.
Oh,
I mean,
nice.
They never got along.
That's nice.
I mean, but that happened in the 50s. Those things, that happens. I've never seen so much hatred for one man as everyone despises Hulk Hogan and the New World Order. I don't think you'd be able to keep it inside of a cage.
Well, they're going to lock that cage. And remember, you can't climb out of it. There is a top on it or a roof on the double cage. It's the 10th year of the match beyond, War Games, the match beyond, and this one, the most important ever.
This will be the last year, I bet. I bet after what they see happens in that cage, they will not allow it to happen again.
Oh, I'm not so sure about that. It just remains to be seen, but I know what you're saying. It is really going to be quite an explosive event. Renegade now trying to get outside, and Randy Yellow, the referee, moving him back. Right now, the Gambler buying a lot of time. What he is doing, in effect, here, is slowing down the momentum of this big guy.
No, he's drawing three.
Drawing three.
That's right. If you draw one, you get one card. Three, he gets time to look at each card. He gets time to put them in his hands. That's what he's doing. He's going for a full house. He's going for a straight.
You listen to some of the things you say sometimes?
Never.
Into the corner, trying to draw him in there. And that's what he did. He went right to the eyes. And a right hand to the side of the head. Full arm drag, it twists. And a reversal. Renegade just too powerful. You get that close to that guy, and the power comes through.
Well, the Gambler's a smart guy, too.
He's a smart guy.
You agree with me.
He comes to the ring with a deck of cards.
And not a full deck. See how smart he is? If he had all his cards, you'd know what he has. You see? This way, when he brings as many cards as he wants, he knows how many cards he has. So you not knowing how many cards he has, only he knows. That's why he's the gambler. Your bet.
Holy Moses, I'll pass.
I win.
On that one.
Give me $50.
I'm not. Forget it.
No, right, you folded.
I passed. I didn't.
Same thing.
Can we get back to the match here?
Same
Here's the
thing
lateral press. One. It is not the
same thing when you're playing Crazy Renegades. That's what we always
it's
play not, here.
It's Crazy Eights.
No, here we're playing Crazy Renegades.
And we're seeing one here, too. And the gambler, with the knee to the side of the head, the gambler on the attack. Again, right hand. And he's got a lot of steam behind that right hand. And an elbow on the back of the head. But we have a tremendous hour of worldwide, including Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Scott Norton, and the crippler Chris Benoit, the Pitbull Sergeant Craig Pittman. With Teddy Long. And I have it on good authority. We are only getting better as the weeks to come with the great talent in World Championship Wrestling right here each week on Worldwide.
Well, you know, you watch Worldwide, you watch Pro, you watch Main Event, you watch Saturday Night, you watch Nitro. They just keep getting better, don't they?
And, of course, the place to be is pay-per-view. And on Sunday, September 15th, if you call your local cable operator, of course, maybe you have a gigantic satellite dish at home or the mini-disc with DirecTV, then you can join us on pay-per-view television. Make that important phone call. Sunday, September 15th at 7 o'clock. It will originate the event from Winston-Salem, North Carolina, in the Lawrence Joel Memorial Coliseum.
Look at the power of this renegade. He's coming out of it. That's what to do. Knee him in the back of the head, of course.
Knee him in the back of the head.
Man's in front of you pulling your arms apart. What are you supposed to do?
Knee
you
him
can't
the,
grab him.
That's right. Back elbow, put renegade down. The gambler, lateral press. One only that time. And a kick out.
What do you think about this Nick Patrick situation?
I think the jury's still out on Nick Patrick. I think innocent until proven guilty.
Now, a lot of times he looks like he may be making a mistake, then sometimes he's right on the money. He's right there in position. The 1-2-3 count's right there. He knows what he's doing. I mean, the man is a gifted referee. He's been a referee a long time. He's well known. He's probably the most respected. I can't see him going the other way.
Well, you know, you, Bobby the Brain Heenan, you know more about cheating and how to cheat and have cheated more than anyone in the history of the sport. So you should know a cheat when you see one.
I've never liked the guy.
Well, that's giving him a vote of confidence then.
See what he means to me. Now bet me on that.
No,
we'll
I'm
talk
not bet-
to the gambler.
I'm not betting you anymore. I passed, and you tried
you
to take
folded.
I didn't fold. There's an elbow to try to get out of it by the renegade. Big forearm shot, and that staggered him. Here comes the gambler shooting renegade. Renegade reverses fields here.
Oh!
Slam! Yeah. Renegade feeling the effects of the gambler.
See, his head's always moving.
Yep.
He's like that dog in the back of a car. You ever see that
dog?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes. Or the little baseball doll. Right hand gambler making two of them. That's forearm shots. Renegade blocked it. Renegade. Right hand to his own. Renegade. The gambler back to the corner. Renegade shoots him in. Renegade.
Oh!
Handspring sends him to the corner. The gambler reeling from that, and he bulldogs him down.
The old Greco-Roman butt block. You don't see much of that anymore.
You never see it. Two and three.
Thank
over.
Goodness.
Here is your winner, the Renegade.
Now watch his hair. He'll start moving. Want another cup of coffee? Uh-huh.
I'm back. And I'm better than ever.
How about a donut? Come on, Renegade. Move that head. Hello, ladies. You're cheering for me, aren't you? Here on Worldwide. Where's Tony?
All right, fans, still to come this week on Worldwide, Chris Benoit, the Four Horsemen, going up against the Pitbull Sergeant Craig Pittman. Speaking of the Four Horsemen, fans, as you know, Fall Brawl right around the corner, only on pay-per-view in 2 weeks on Sunday, September 15th. It will be members of the Horsemen, Arn Anderson, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, going up with Lex Luger and Sting as their partners against members of the New World Order. Unprecedented, the Horsemen teaming with Lex Luger and Sting.
Well, you know, when Russia and America got together, people said it had to happen. When the wall came down, they said, that makes sense. But people are still talking about the Horsemen, Luger, and Sting, how they're going to work together as a unit. They're going to work together as a unit, and I'll tell you why.
because behind that unit is WCW, and in front of that unit is NWO, and it's all going to take place inside two rings inside of a steel cage. NWO guys, pack your luggage.
Absolutely. We know of four WCW athletes. We only know of three NWO men right now, as we'll be back after this timeout on Worldwide.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by Slim Jim. When you need a little excitement, snap into a beefy, spicy Slim Jim. Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Dentine gum. In less than 60 seconds, Dentine's tingly taste will make your breath feel fresh and clean. Brush your breath with Dentine.
Jim! Gotta have beef. Gotta have spice. Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah!
When you build a country by hand, you're going to get a little dirty doing it. And for 100 years, Pumice Powered Lava has been cleaning the hands that make America strong.
We are back with you on Worldwide. Tony Schiavone, Bobby the Brain Heenan, one of Heenan's favorite wrestlers, making his way to the ring right now. And it's not only because the man really knows how to wrestle, but it's because the man is a big bankroll. We're talking about VK Wall Street.
Boy, does he have some tips for me. He's got some tips on NASDAQ. He's got some tips on New York Stock Market Exchange. The man, if you want to invest in a fertilizer farm in Iowa, he's got a place for you.
I'll pass on that. I lost all my money betting with you in the first match. Johnny Boone, his opponent.
It's his dad has a winery.
Whose dad has a winery?
Johnny Boone's. Ever hear of Boone's Farm?
Here's the bell, and here we go. It's VK Wall Street and Johnny Boone in this one-on-one matchup. And fans, don't forget, World Championship Wrestling presents Fall Brawl exclusively on pay-per-view, coming your way Sunday, September 15th, from the Lawrence Joel Veterans Memorial Coliseum. That'll be in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And we invite you fans to join us there, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, exclusively on pay-per-view. We'll start at 5:30 in the Winston-Salem Coliseum.
You know, another thing Mr. Wall Street doesn't like is people like Okerlund and you referring to him as Walmart. And the fans call him Walmart. So you got to mention that too, don't you? Just so the people will get on his case. That's not nice to do. The man has nothing to do with Walmart, which is a great store.
But
he has nothing to do with it. The man is Wall Street. There's a difference between Walmart and Wall Street. In Wall Street, you don't stand in line. And at Walmart...
Well, they really get under his skin with that chant, and I don't see why, because, well, I guess he feels that's below him. I'm not sure, but nevertheless, VK Wall Street is a prolific wrestler. Look at that, what he calls a butterfly suplex.
Walmart's a great store.
Yes, it is.
Gene buys all his suits there.
I'm sure he does.
And a car.
I'm sure you can buy tires there.
If you have a car, of course you need tires. You don't buy tires if you need a suit.
Now, Johnny Boone is swinging wildly here.
I guess something's happened to his little cap and his tail. Snap him in half, VK. You know what VK stands for, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Very keen.
Very keen?
That's what they say about this man on Wall Street. He's very keen, very shrewd.
Not very cute, but very keen.
Cute starts with a C.
Oh, yes, it does. That's why you're the brain.
Well, that's why I'm cute.
Right in the abdomen, the lower abdomen. And that was very close to being a low blow, but apparently not as... Well, there's Nick Patrick there. Checking in. And the jury is still out on him as well.
But, you know, you watch Nick Patrick here. He's doing a job. He's telling Wall Street to back off. He's counting.
Here's a roll-up from Johnny Boone. He got a two-count that time.
Right in position. Nick Patrick right there in position. Getting out of the way of the action.
Up.
So much for Mr. Boone.
Stock market crash from VK Wall Street. Puts him away with a three-count, and VK Wall Street wins once again. Well, he had a big win. If you'll recall, the Clash of the Champions against Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Duggan got the return fire on him recently on Nitro.
I need to know some more about this XL stock. I want to talk to him afterwards. This man puts me on to everything. You know, he got me fixed up with an accountant last year.
I bet he did.
And I paid close to $40-some in tax. I mean, cost a little, but the man's worth it. There you see, Mr. Wall Street dropping Mr. Boone right on the tail of his little cap.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan coming up next, but right now, fans on Worldwide, we take you to Mean Gene Okerlund.
Hi again, fans. We're back in the control center heading to that yearly pay-per-view spectacular fall brawl between the War Games. The event is going to be 2 weeks from this Sunday, Sunday, September the 15th, beginning at 7 o'clock. Call your cable operator right now to ensure availability. Satellite dish owners, contact Turner Premier or DirecTV. It is nothing less than a blockbuster. Lex Luger and Sting to team with Arn Anderson and Ric Flair to represent WCW against the NWO in War Games. The NWO's team will consist of Hulk Hogan and the Outsiders, Paul and Nash. But what about the fourth man? WCW has four, the NWO? Well, odds are that this mystery fourth man will finally make his appearance at Fall Brawl. Remember, the confines of a double ring steel cage is without a doubt the most dangerous battleground in professional wrestling history. Combine that with the collision between WCW and the NWO, and you have all the makings for one of the single biggest events in the history of this sport. Now, in other action for the WCW World Tag Team title, Harlem Heat with Colonel Parker and Sister Sherry will defend against the Nasty Boys. The Giant goes one-on-one with the Macho Man, Randy Savage. WCW Cruiserweight title also on the line as champ Rey Mysterio Jr. meets one of his arch rivals from Mexico, Super Calo. Ladies and gentlemen, from top to bottom, you're not going to find any better action than what we have in store for you at Fall Brawl. Be a part of that action of War Games as the best in WCW meet the upstart New World Order. Make your plans to join us right now. Call your local cable operator. Satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier at 1-800-843-9266. DirecTV, 1-800-347-3288. Don't be left out. Make that call right now.
The superstars of World Championship Wrestling are here each and every week on the nation's number one wrestling syndicated program around the world. We are seen in New York City, Los Angeles, the Chicagoland area, all points in between, down in Florida, up in South Dakota. We are Worldwide Wrestling.
And this man right here, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, is the biggest favorite at Bellevue.
Bellevue?
The Nut House. They love him there. They relate to him.
You know, I beg to differ with you. I have really had a chance to get to know Hacksaw Jim Duggan over the past year. He is a great person. Not only that, he's a very intelligent man. Now, I know he comes... Would you settle down for 1 second? I know he comes out. He waves the flag. There's his opponent, Steve Storm. He comes out and he waves the flag. And he shouts, thumbs up, everything. And he's the blue-collar champion. But he's a very... You ready for this? He's a very intelligent man. And he starts to chant... Would you stop, please? He starts to chant of USA. He is. Okay. The people from Bellevue are going to come here to get the brain here anytime soon. Storm sends Duggan back. A slap to the chest. Here's the whip in, sending Storm the other side. You can join me anytime here, Brain. A slam down. You're really earning your money on this one, I can tell you that. Right hand, side of the head. USA, here you go. USA, what a powerful man he is. Wouldn't you agree, Brain? The chant of USA, Duggan now. And Randy Eller moves him back. Well, I'll come back to you in a moment, Brain. As soon as you gather yourself here. Duggan getting the fans behind him. Storm from the neutral position, side headlock. Right hand. Wanted to go with it, and he's back to the corner once again. This is where you can get in trouble if you're in the corner, right, Brain? This is unbelievable. Somebody get the hook. Brain is dropped off the face of the earth. The chant of USA. USA, USA is the chant. Duggan, former United States heavyweight champion. And what's so funny about that? That's fact. Duggan is. An elbow. Duggan, a man who comes right out of that three-point stance with that big clothesline of his. Former football player. I mean, he is. He was a tremendous college football player.
College!
He really was. And take a look at the power that is Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Back to the corner. Sending Storm in. Here he comes. The big power slam. Spinning. Grabs the hair and puts him down. And here he comes. The three-point stance that he learned in college. Oh, there it is. One, two, three. You can't deny the ability of Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Are you okay now?
Fine. Is there a replay?
Yeah, but let me take care of this.
No,
one,
no,
okay?
Let me do it. Please allow me.
Yeah, let him earn his money this match.
Mm-hmm. Allow me.
He's got the fist tape. There it is, Brain. The tape on the fist. Hacksaw Jim Duggan wins the match. Tapes the fist and means business as well. Brain, it's all yours.
Well, here's your educated college man. Slamming his opponent down. He jumps in the air, hits him in the mouth. That's your college grad there. Football player, intelligent man. Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Let's see if we can't get Duggan to come over here. Jim? Here, he's on his way here. All right, we're going to be talking to Duggan during the commercial break, aren't we, Brain? And we'll be back with more after this.
I got to go get a coke.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
I always like to keep my favorite snack handy. Need a little excitement? Step into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah!
Dentine gum. In less than 60 seconds, Dentine's tingly taste will make your breath feel fresh and clean. Brush your breath with Dentine.
They're on with the new Laramie Super Soap. XXP275 and 175. Four times the payload of your original Super Soap. New Laramie Super Soap and XXP. Sweater is better!
The superstars of World Championship Wrestling come together for one unique night. And that is Sunday, September 15th. Exclusively on pay-per-view as WCW presents Fall Brawl featuring War Games The Match Beyond. But War Games The Match Beyond being the feature bout, being the most dangerous match in our sport, is the main event. There's much more to go, though, including this man, Scott Flash Norton, to face his former tag team partner, Ice Train. They have faced each other before, but this time, Brain, it will be a submission match. The only way to win is to get your opponent to submit. And we've seen Scott Norton with those submission holds after the shoulder breaker be very dangerous in the ring.
And he's 100%. Ice Train is wounded. He's got that bad shoulder, bad arm. He's hurt at the hands of Scott Norton. Norton's going to win this one. He's going to win it easily.
What, you mean this one or the one at...
Well, this one he's going to naturally win easily. First of all, his opponent. That's not Greg the Hammer Valentine. No, that's just somebody that bought a robe and wants to look like him.
That's Buddy Valentine.
That'll hurt.
Chopping him to the chest, right hand, and he is having no effect on Scott Flash Norton. We have seen this happen so many times. People try to take Scott Norton down. There's a dropkick, got him off his feet, and he's going to pay for that. Fans, don't forget our fans in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Tickets available at the Lawrence Joel Coliseum, at the box office, and all Ticketmaster locations for WCW's premier fall event, Fall Brawl, featuring War Games. The match will be on Sunday, September 15th.
I like Norton. What a powerful man. Doesn't have a whole lot of competition here. No competition, really. But he's going to have competition with Ice Train.
You know, and that's a good point. He is going to have competition with Ice Train, but Norton has made it look so easy in the ring, the way he has just absolutely run through the talent here in WCW. I mean, you're talking about a man with a winning streak. This big guy really has one.
And I don't think that many people know that much about him. He's really a very, very mean man. I mean, he's very hard to get to know. He's got an attitude problem, a lot of people say. He feels persecuted. He's paranoid. He thinks everyone's against him. Plus, he's one big, tough customer.
I think you can see that. You can see that demeanor, what you've just been talking about, in Scott Flash Norton. There's a slam out of the corner. Now, Buddy Valentine is over 300 pounds, and he picked him up with ease that time. Scott Norton just stomping away. He likes to intimidate his opponents as well.
What a arm wrestling champion this man was. They call him Flash.
That's right, because he would beat you in a flash in arm wrestling. It wouldn't take long. Scott Norton, truly one of the most powerful men. Big clothesline. One, two, three. He completely disposed of Buddy Valentine.
This was a no competition.
That's right. This was a no contest right here. And that's the way it's been mostly around WCW when Scott Norton gets in the ring. No competition. But the big competition is a man who's not 100%. Former tag team partner now, arch enemy Ice Train. Coming up at Fall Brawl Sunday, September 15th.
Well, Ice Train's going to have to make Scott Norton submit, or Scott Norton, Flash Norton's going to have to make Ice Train submit. Ice Train's got a bad wing. He's wounded. Norton's 100%. If you're a betting man, put your money with Norton.
Your winner is Scott Flash Norton, and coming up next is the main event on Worldwide. But right now, we take you to Gene Okerlund.
Gene Okerlund back here in the control center as the pay-per-view spectacular Fall Brawl featuring War Games rapidly approaches. The event 2 weeks from this Sunday, September the 15th, beginning at 7 Eastern time. Call your cable operator right now to ensure availability. Satellite dish owners, contact Turner Premier, or of course you can call DirecTV. Before we talk about War Games in other action at Fall Brawl, a grudge match. Chavo Guerrero Jr. meets Diamond Dallas Page. Hey, here's one where the only way to win is to force your opponent to submit. Scott Norton meets his former partner, Ice Train. And the Mexican heavyweight champion, Conan, a man sporting a brand new attitude, defends against psychosis. Now for War Games. We are all still in shock that Lex Luger and Sting are going to be teaming up with Arn Anderson and Ric Flair to represent World Championship Wrestling against the NWO in War Games, but it's official. The NWO's team will consist of Hulk Hogan and the Outsiders, Hall and Nash. And we are still waiting to find out who that mysterious fourth man will be. The confines of the double ring, and of course the steel cage, without a doubt, the most dangerous setting, the most dangerous battleground in professional wrestling history. This is one WCW fans from around the world have been waiting for. It's Fall Brawl. Be part of the action of War Games as WCW meets the new world order. Make plans to join us. Call your cable operator right now. Satellite dish owners, contact Turner Premier. Here's the number, 1-800-843-9266. Or DirecTV at 1-800-347-3288. Ladies and gentlemen, don't be left out. This is a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Certainly once a year, WCW against the New World Order. It's all going to be part of Fall Brawl, the War Games. Join us Sunday, September 15th, for this big pay-per-view.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by the godfather of World Championship Wrestling, Teddy Long. From Paris Island, South Carolina, Sergeant Craig, Pitbull Pittman.
Stand at attention wherever you are. The Pitbull Craig Pittman is out. Former all-military champion, now a solid pro in World Championship Wrestling, guided by Teddy Long.
And also known on the barracks as KP Pittman.
No, that's not the case. That's not true. Teddy Long, also the man guiding the career of Ice Train, a man who has to go up against Scott Norton at the Big pay-per-view coming up, and Teddy Long just making his way back now into competition after being brutally attacked recently by the Giant. We send you back to David Penzer in the ring.
His opponent, representing the Four Horsemen, from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, the Crippler, Chris.
Many people call him Mr. Intensity. Some competitors secretly call him the Wolverine. He is the most intense individual in our sport, aptly named the Crippler, because when he is on, odds are you're not going to walk out of the ring.
And he's always on, believe me, or he wouldn't be a horseman.
And he's coming back with us for our main event after this timeout on Worldwide.
Yeah.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by Twix Cookie Bars. Need a timeout? Need to? Take a timeout with Twix.
And the main event begins here on Worldwide. You know, one thing we have here, Brain, if you size up these two men, you have the Crippler, and you have a man you're looking at right now, the Pit Bull, Craig Pittman, who will not be intimidated by Chris Benoit. Intimidation, a big part of the Horseman, a big part of Chris Benoit.
Well, one thing about Pittman, he has been on the mat with the best. And he's got Teddy Long right now in his corner. But he doesn't have the ring time in as Benoit. He's not the world traveler as Benoit, and he's not a horseman. So the edge has to go to Benoit, just for the matter of experience. Pittman's going to be all right, and Teddy Long is going to make sure that his bank account grows. Not Pittman's, Teddy Long's. You see, because I know what Teddy Long's been up to. He's been scamming off his guys. That's just between you and I. I don't want to get out anyplace else.
I don't believe that at all. As a matter of fact, I don't believe it because I know Teddy Long, and I don't believe it because it's coming from you. So
Tony,
strike one, strike two.
Tony, when I told you Hulk Hogan was a miserable human being 6 months ago, what did you tell me?
You were wrong.
What is Hulk Hogan now to you, Tony?
He's a miserable human being right now, Brain.
Don't give Teddy Long any cash.
Pitbull getting the power advantage, leverage advantage here from the Greco-Roman knuckle lock, and now they go behind, trying to push him right down to the mat. But Benoit has a great vertical base, and look how Benoit turns that. Oh, Pitbull had him rolled up. 1-2, but Benoit's too close to the ropes. Pitbull could have had a 1-2-3 there, and that just goes to show you the mat wrestling ability of Craig Pitbull Pittman. I know Benoit's one of the best, but Pitbull, if he gets you on the mat, can beat you.
See, what Teddy Long wants to do is, he knows Pittman's got the ability on that mat to wrestle. There's no doubt about it. This man is wrestling from head to toe. But now Teddy Long needs to teach him what WCW wrestling's about. How a guy's going to stick a thumb in your eye. How to avoid that. How to you stick your thumb in that guy's eye. How to just be a little more aggressive. How to be a little more hungry. Forget medals. Forget wins. Go for cash.
There's always the underlying factor that the Horsemen could be around somewhere. Benoit, Mongo McMichael, Arn Anderson, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. Arn Anderson and Ric Flair teaming up with Sting and Lex Luger together as a unit. And they'll be going up against the, as Pitbull puts him down, going up against the members of the NWO, Hulk Hogan, Hall and Nash, the Outsiders, fourth member. Well, we haven't seen him yet. But you can better believe
if he's going to appear, he will appear at
Fall Brawl. No question. If they want to even up the sides, there are four WCW men there. Only three that we know of now. More than likely, we are going to see that fourth man, I would think.
I mean, now it's
Fall Brawl. Of course, you never know.
Well, now it's their time to show us what they got. They came in here with a heck of an entrance. You got to admit that. I mean, they beat up a lot of people with ball bats. They hurt Eric Bischoff. They shook Gene Okerlund around. Well, let's see now. They spray-painted the WCW belt. Let's see now. In a cage, two rings, four against four. If you got four, bring them. If you don't, bring what you have. But I'll bet you something, Tony. If there is a fourth or a fifth, if we're going to see them, we'll see them at Fall Brawl.
One would think, but you never know what they're doing or what they're thinking. Hogan, Hall, and Nash could walk to the ring at Fall Brawl. Just three of them. The match gets underway, and then maybe a fourth or fifth or sixth man arrive.
Or maybe the fourth or fifth man is already in that ring.
Mm-hmm. Good point.
Or near the ring.
Or under the ring and cut his way through the mat. We've seen that happen in this sport.
You never know what can happen here at WCW. Something's going to happen at Fall Brawl. War Games. Inside of a steel cage. Two rings. You can bet on that.
Benoit really approaching this match a lot differently than usual. I mean, he is really tentative here, and I guess that's out of respect for the ability of his opponent.
You know something? A lot of people couldn't understand why Benoit and McMichaels backed out of it and allowed Sting and Luger to team with the Horsemen. I'll tell you why. That shows you how bad the Horsemen, and we here at WCW want to destroy this image, this myth, this new world organization. Benoit realizes exactly what Flair and Arn Anderson know about Sting and Luger. So they might be better than he would be at that particular point. You don't know. It'd be harder for the New World Order to go against, wouldn't it?
Sure would be.
And McMichael, the team player.
He even said it.
And Deborah, his wife, is a beautiful woman, isn't she?
Absolutely gorgeous. Pulling both arms back now.
She likes you too, Tony.
I know she does.
I heard her tell me the other day when you went by, she's Chet that kisser.
The chant of USA gets the pit bull back into this thing now.
And then you went by the other day, I heard her say, get him.
Into the ropes goes Chris Benoit, and Benoit took advantage of that situation. As Randy Ellis was calling for the break and the pit bull took a step back, he got a elbow flush in the right eye that time. Boy, Benoit, so many ways to defeat you, so many ways to win a match for this man.
See, this is what Teddy Long has to do. This man's been on the mat.
He's had enough of this brain.
He's got to teach him to fight. If you want it, fight. And that's what Long's going to do, but this is the wrong man to fight, Chris Benoit, the Crippler.
Now, here he goes, Mr. Intensity, but no.
Ooh.
The pit bull will have none of it.
Wait a minute here.
He's firing back.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe Teddy Long has taught him to fight here. Headbutts, shoots him into the corner, the neutral corner, right side.
He's kind of having his way with the Crippler, isn't he?
How about it? He's climbing the ropes, a dangerous place to be with the Crippler, but he's going into it anyway. See, the Crippler's got him now. He's got him hooked. Oh! Inverted atomic drop.
But what you do when a man drops you like that, you hold on to the back of his hair and bring him right over with you. Those are things he's going to have to learn.
Good counter move that time, Brian. Yeah,
it was. I did that on an escalator once where a woman was begging.
Hey, would you stop? Snapmare takeover.
Big woman, though.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure.
Yeah, well, right. Of course that gray hair is when you've got hold of it.
Would you please stop with these stories? The chant of USA, and right now Benoit is content with keeping Pitbull on the mat. And that's odd in itself. A good look at Teddy Long, manager extraordinaire, a man who's a great motivator, a former referee. That's how he started in this sport, as a referee. And he had some very outspoken comments about Nick Patrick's recent.
And he's manager of the year?
Yes, he's been.
And I hope this match is over within an hour and a half.
You do?
Well, Teddy does. He has to have his suit back. Will he sew up the back for the rest of the stiff?
Fans are getting behind the pit bull here, but right now he's on the mat. Teddy Long leading the charge on the outside. Pit bull on the mat trying to get up, but Benoit, and he has tremendous upper body strength, great development in the biceps and the triceps. He's a very strong individual.
So quick, too.
Yeah, when you're in that headlock, you're in trouble. The pit bull breaks away, and down he goes.
See, he should have broke away a little later. He should have worn the Crippler down a little bit. But he's going to learn that in the ring. You will learn all that through doing.
Referee Randy Eller and Teddy Long having some words there as well. Here's a hook over the top. Bridge suplex, 1-2, no.
You know, the bad thing about wrestling the pit bull and picking him up by his head and touching his head and putting him in a headlock and looking at Teddy Long is, it's very bad, it's very bad.
It is?
Well, because usually within an hour you have a desire to go bowling.
The fans certainly are behind the pit bull here, but Benoit is in command with a reverse chin lock. Teddy Long is complaining to the referee that is a chokehold, but as you can clearly see,
Teddy Long is lying.
You know, Teddy Long is blocked out here. He just wants to make sure.
No, Teddy Long is a liar. You know what he told me about you? He said you were Gene Okerlund's brother-in-law on his sister's side. Removed twice.
I might be.
To the will.
I might be.
Well, then he could be right.
Okerlund never did get along with his in-laws. An elbow.
Because he had more hair than them.
He's got him.
Got him down. No, sir.
Too close to the ropes.
He was in the ropes, and Benoit came storming out of the ropes that time.
You know, and at War Games, don't think for a minute that Steve Mongo, McMichaels, and Benoit are not going to be in attendance. They will be there. If they have to take bolt cutters, the jaws of life, and get their way through that cage, underneath the cage, or over the top, something is going to happen to the NWO, or something's going to happen to us. It's either do it or don't.
I agree. Pitbull moves out of the way here. And Benoit seizing the opportunity once again. Such an opportunistic wrestler he is.
Watch, he sat there. He knew he had him. Oh!
Pitbull! He set him up!
He snatched him and threw him over the top. Pitbull covers him. One, two, got a two count. My goodness, what a move that was. Out of desperation by Craig Pittman.
I thought Benoit had him set up. I thought he knew the man was wounded. I thought he was going to hit the ropes and drop a knee on him. But it seemed to me like Pittman set him up. He let the man think he was hurt more than he was. Not bad. Not bad at all.
Pitbull firing back on Benoit. We've got fisticuffs going here, and these two men are giving it their all. Look at this, if you will. In the corner. Pounding away. The Pitbull and Benoit. Right in your living room now. Or your kitchen, wherever you are here. Sending Benoit now to the left side. The battering ram. That was right below the sternum, and Benoit may be out of it. He went down in a heap. And the pit bull, Kenny Long says, cover him, finish him off.
Code red, he's going for it.
He stalked him, and that was the mistake.
He wasted a little too much time.
Exactly.
Had he pulled the crippler in the middle of the ring, he could have had him. He could have had the win of his life.
And meanwhile, the crippler rebounds from that, misses an elbow. Cross body, one, two. Benoit's out in two. In the corner, Pitbull. In hard, Benoit covers. Foot on the ropes, he's got a leg and he's got the three count. And Benoit steals one from the Pitbull, Craig Pittman.
Oh, yes.
He earned every ounce of that one.
Does it get any better?
Remember the Horsemen, the Crippler Chris Benoit wins once again here on Worldwide Wrestling, our feature event. I tell you, Brian, this was a good matchup.
Right here you see Craig Pitbull Pittman hit those ropes. Going to knock Benoit down, but it backfired him. The Canadian Crippler, one member of the Horsemen, Chris Benoit. What's it going to be like in War Games? With Flair, Anderson, Sting, and Luger together on one side, not knowing where Benoit, Steve McMichaels, the other two members of the Horsemen will be. Somebody better watch out. Members of the NWO, if you're listening to me, make sure your papers are in order. We may have seen you for the last time. You're a winner. Little use of the ropes, so what? The Crippler, Chris Benoit. Oh, yeah.
You know, Brain, one thing as we head to Fall Brawl we must remark on is the fact that Chris Benoit and Steve Mongo McMichael kind of left out when you talk about War Games. However, the Horsemen, Arn Anderson and Ric Flair got the blessing of Benoit and Steve Mongo McMichael to team with Lex Luger and Sting on the 15th.
When you say left out, you don't understand the situation. Benoit and McMichaels understand that Arn and Flair have been in the ring with Sting and Luger more than anybody, so they know each other. So to win this thing, they're taking a step back. Mongo has a Super Bowl ring from the Chicago Bears. He's a team player. He's taking a step back. Don't you see what's happening, NWO? You are on your way out of nothing.
We are on our way out, but back in next week with more Worldwide. For the Brain, I'm Tony Schiavone. See you next week.
Ready in tag team action against Harlem Heat.
And my favorite man with all the moves, the Disco Inferno, will be here taking on Conan.
Plus, Diamond Dallas Page in singles competition.
And the Face of the Fear with Jimmy Hart take on two members of the Four Horsemen right here on Worldwide.
That's all coming up next from the Disney MGM Studios. Bobby the Brain Heenan, this is Tony Schiavone. Welcome to the Worldwide Arena with the superstars of WCW World Championship Wrestling this week on Worldwide. As always, a capacity crowd ready for the great wrestling action that is World Championship Wrestling. And Brain, we start out now 1 week away from Fall Brawl with the awesome team of Rough and Ready.
Dirty.
That's right, Mike. He is one of the toughest men going in this sport on the face of the earth. Dirty Dick Slater. And they can knock anybody off at any given time.
Ladies and gentlemen, what
a shirt.
I guess it is. What a tremendous way to start this program. We are going to begin with a tag team war as of sorts, and a war that is centering on really a couple of people, Colonel Robert Parker and Sister Sherry, because they will be coming out here with Harlem Heat, and it wasn't too long ago, Brain, right here at the Disney MGM Studios, Colonel Parker walked down with Rough and Ready.
That's right. Obviously, something concerning business has changed, or is it the love of a woman?
Gotta be a love of a woman, I would think.
You know, the Colonel does get smitten every now and then.
Yeah.
About 4 times an hour.
Here comes Sister Sherry.
As lovely as ever.
Yes, she is, along with Harlem Heat. And, of course, Colonel Parker in tow. They are the WCW World Tag Team Champions. And, of course, coming up at Fall Brawl next Sunday, exclusively on pay-per-view, these two men will defend the World Tag Team belts against the Nasty Boys. And Colonel Parker certainly has want to get in the ring and have his men get in the ring with the Nasty Boys, Brain.
Well, I'll tell you, the Nasty Boys get in a bad position, and one of them gets hurt or both of them get hurt, I wouldn't be surprised if Colonel would take that cane ahead and just tee off on their heads like some Titleist golf balls. Because, you know, they put their hands on Sherry.
Yes, they did.
And nobody does that to the squeeze of the Colonel.
1 week fans removed from Fall Brawl, as we said, where WCW will go into the most dangerous match in the history of our sport, War Games. Two rings, two cages, in the ultimate battleground to defend the honor of WCW. Horsemen, two of them, Ric Flair and Arn Anderson, with Sting and Lex Luger as their partners, against members of the NWO.
You know, there's been a lot of feuds in this sport. There's been a lot of people that just didn't really like each other and never have liked each other. Some great matches, some great feuds. But, Tony, you have to agree with me. This is a war. No other way to look at it.
Pro wrestlers have never seen anything like this transpired right before your eyes over the past couple of months on these television programs. The insurgence of the NWO, the attempts they have made. As a matter of fact, recently on Nitro, spray painting not only our Turner production truck outside of the arena live on Nitro when we were in Palmetto, Florida, but a couple of weeks ago as we saw attacking all the members of the Horsemen like no one has ever done in the sport, and spray painting and humiliating the Horsemen. And now Stevie Ray, the big guy, in the corner, trying to fight out, and he's taking on both men here.
Well, Slater will give him a fight for it. So will Stevie Ray, though.
Big side headlock. Stevie Ray is a big, scrappy man with a shoulder block takedown. And Dick Slater thinks better of that, and he takes the low rope, but Stevie Ray is going to chase him down.
Looks like he just got off a ride here at Disney.
It looks like he just came right off the Tower of Terror.
Without the elevator.
Well, that would be tough. As we heard in the program, a Diamond Dallas is here, the face of fear, and Horseman in our main event, Disco Inferno against Conan. And much more to come here on this one-hour edition of Worldwide. 1 week, fans, don't forget, Fall Brawl comes your way next Sunday, September 15th. The bell time is 7 o'clock. This is an exclusive pay-per-view telecast. Here's a roll-up by Slater. 1, 2, almost got the 3 count that time.
Very hard to hold a man that big, that strong of chest and arms down in a move like that. You almost have to have him almost unconscious or have a good hook on his trunk.
To the side of the head goes Stevie Ray, and Dick Slater down in the corner begging off here now. And the referee for the first bout is Randy Anderson, and he tries to assert himself here.
See, with Dick Slater, you never know if he's playing possum, if you've got him hurt. Usually when you got Slater hurt, that's when he's the most dangerous.
Well, he's such a great veteran. He has been in the ring countless times. And the certainly of all the men in the ring here in this opening bout, he is the one senior member here, the veteran. And he's got Mike Enos quite a partner. Enos, in a very short span here in World Championship Wrestling, has turned a lot of heads, made quite a name for himself because of his throw caution to the wind style. He is fearless. And right now, he's caught in a real tough spot in this corner.
Well, don't forget, Harlem Heat has been together a lot longer. They're brothers. They grew up together. They've been tag team wars together. This team of Rough and Ready is relatively new, but with Slater's experience and this man's eagerness and aggression, they could knock off Harlem Heat. No doubt about it. What I like about Enos, If I was still managed, I'd love to have him. You could really groom him. He's got that energy. He's got that excitement level. Like you say, he'll throw caution to the wind. He'll take a lot of chances. He'll make you a lot. I mean, he'll make us all.
Oh, he will, huh?
Well, he could.
Yeah. Then how come Colonel Parker walked away from him?
Well, maybe he didn't see what I saw in him. I'm not saying the Colonel's wrong, but everybody looks for a different thing. Don't forget, Colonel's in love. I'm not.
I guess so. And Sherry and Dick Slater having an argument in the background there. Meanwhile, in the ring, Mike Enos, and it's got to be tough. It had to be tough for Enos and Slater up and ready to stay focused with Colonel in their corner in love with Sherry, but even more so now that Colonel and Sherry are on the opposite side. Here is a leapfrog.
Ooh.
And Booker T on target with an elbow, right hand. Making a forearm, a scoop slam on Slater as Enos is still winded. And the fans are going nuts here at Disney, and there's another one.
Welcome to the Harlem Heat Tower of Terror. That's Stevie Ray and Booker T. All four in there now.
Jump wheel kick on target. And outside, down to the floor, goes Booker T. Dick Slater with him, and I do, or make that Mike Enos with him. And I do believe the...
You know, this is a mistake on Enos' part. He can't beat Stevie Ray out there. Well, it has to be done in the ring. Now, you got this man on the floor, Stevie Ray, Booker T. Doesn't really matter. That's when you and your partner Slater should gang up on the other guy and do as much damage as you can as quick as you can.
Absolutely. And Sherry up on the apron trying to get the attention of Randy Anderson. Meanwhile, back in the ring. Here we go. The action continues. Back in the ring with a jumping pile driver.
He didn't get him good, though.
I don't think he did either. One, two, and he kicked out of it. You're right, Green. Did not get him that good, and that could have been a mistake as Stevie Ray and Booker T, the World Tag Team Champ, still in this one.
Every time you put a man in a hold like that, you got to understand what man you're putting in that hold. These men are tag team champions. These men fight the best every night. They're in top physical shape. So when you're going to put a move on him to take him out, you better have that move on him 100%. You better give him a 10.
You know, I don't think I've ever seen Colonel Parker as mad as Sherry's got the cigar stuck in her mouth, for crying out loud.
Is he fanning himself or her?
I don't know what he's doing. I don't think I've ever seen him as mad as what happened on a recent edition of WCW Saturday Night when we were in Colorado Springs, Colorado, and we talked about it earlier. The Nasty Boys hit the ring. They were very upset that they've not been considered a contender for the World Tag Team title, at least by Harlem Heat. And they made their presence known, and they got what they wanted, the World Tag Team title match at Fall Brawl. Here's a cover, one, two, got a two count.
Well, a squeaky wheel gets the oil. Sometimes you just have to let yourself be known, maybe make a butt of yourself, or do whatever you have to.
Experience there, huh? Down.
I see enough people do it.
Oh, there you have. Here's a lateral press, one, two, got a two count. Squeaky, what did you say again? Squeaky wheel needs...
Gets the oil.
Gets the oil. Okay, I'll write that one down.
If you start complaining, you may get a raise.
And burn it into the ropes, and down goes Booker T.
Start complaining, you may get a raise. Start complaining.
About what?
Okerman does.
One, two, well, one, two, got a two count. We're having a great time. So good to have you with us on Worldwide. This is World Championship Wrestling where the big boys play. And here it is. Well, he had it set up for it. It was nicely done by Enos, but I tell you, he may be... discounted the intestinal fortitude of one Booker T that time.
And the conditioning.
Yeah.
Before you drop a move like that on him, make sure he's laid out. Put the boots to him a few times.
Stevie Ray makes a save that time. Dick Slater's had enough. And we got a Donnybrook in the corner with the two men on the outside who are on the inside. And here's a thing of a slam. Into the rope. Booker T goes down. We've got a power slam on one end. And Enos could make a cover here. And Colonel
Parker's in.
Colonel Parker's in the ring. And a haymaker sends the Colonel back to Oxford, Mississippi.
Oh, watch this.
Sherry's got the cane.
Oh,
on the top of the head of Enos. And Randy Anderson's all tied up.
He doesn't know where to go.
Now he goes over to the legal man and makes a one, two, and three count.
Who was legal?
Booker T was legal with Mike Enos. And that's where he made the count. And the World Tag Team Champions win yet again. And now await the Nasty Boys. And I tell you, it came down to a case of the numbers here, Brain.
Boy, when Sherry pulled back that cane, I thought it was shades of John Daly going for that long drive. Or maybe
Johnson
Mark McGuire going for the fences.
He's
she
down.
Ran back, boy.
Put your arm out of the way. It can't nobody stop him. Understand me?
Still to come this week on Worldwide, our main event, Face the Fear against members of the Horsemen. I tell you, Brain, not too long ago, we saw the New World Order leading up to Fall Brawl really make an example, I guess is one way to put it, of the Horsemen. No one has ever spray-painted the Horsemen and treated the Horsemen like that.
Well, if Hulk Hogan and his band of merry men from the NWO think they're going to lay the Horsemen out, spray their backs with NWO, spray their hair, and they're going to turn tail and run, you're wrong. You want to paint the town, NWO? We can paint the town here at WCW. Ask Ric Flair.
And we will do it next Sunday, only on pay-per-view at Fall Brawl and War Games. Back with more Worldwide after this.
So noisy here.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by Crispity, Crunchity, Peanut Buttery, Butterfinger Candy Bar. Have a Butterfinger Blast. Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Dentine Gum. In less than 60 seconds, Dentine's tingly taste will make your breath feel fresh and clean. Brush your breath with Dentine.
At Rent-A-Center, you can try it before you buy it, so you never get stuck with anything you don't want. We guarantee it. Call 1-800-546-4900 now to find out how.
Unlike any cream, Absorbine Junior has a unique penetrating ingredient for liquid fast relief. Ah, Absorbine.
You're watching the world's number one wrestling syndicated television program, WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Seen on more stations than any other wrestling program around the world. And we are going to be entertained here a little bit, I guess, by the Disco Inferno.
And you're also watching the man that made Denny Terrio sell his dance shoes. The one that made John Travolta and the Bee Gees quit watching Saturday Night. That man right there, the Fever Man, Disco Inferno.
Can he dance? You're right, he cannot. And as a matter of fact, there's the mirror ball for Disco Inferno. You know, the Disco Inferno comes down with that gold record of his, or that gold CD, as he calls it, and he wants to hit the fans with it. Great appreciation to the fans, huh?
Well, it's a hit.
A top 10 hit, right?
This man dance? Can this man dance?
No, no. To answer both questions.
Yes, he can.
He cannot. Tell you, though, and I've said this many times, it's beating a dead horse. I know the old cliche goes, but if he'd start worried about wrestling a little bit more than concentrating on that, the man can really wrestle when he concentrates.
Well, he needs some direction. He needs a manager. He needs to stay focused.
And he must face a man who has gone through a complete attitude change over the past couple of weeks, the Mexican heavyweight champion Conan.
And probably one of the biggest stars in the history of wrestling in Mexico.
No question about that. Conan, not only an attitude change, but a different look about him as well. How about that?
Obviously, he's been in the attic again playing dress-up.
Well, I don't know about that, but Conan, the Mexican heavyweight champion, has gone through a complete personality change apparently here. Now, Conan will defend his Mexican heavyweight championship against Juventud Guerrera, the young man who we have seen on many of our television programs, who is a 21-year-old sensation, a former tag team champion in Mexico, is Juventud, and a man who has so many spectacular moves. And I tell you, I really believe Conan, for all his attitude changes and everything, really more than ever has his work cut out for him in that prestigious Mexican heavyweight championship.
You know, and the ironic thing is the man can wrestle. The man can do aerial moves. He can wrestle on that mat. He can pound it out with you. He can wrestle on the floor. He can do anything a 200-pounder can do. He's a big, strong, tough guy, but now, being here in the United States, I think he thinks he has to push people around to survive. And you know something? He may be right.
Drop toe hold, and there you see Conan now. On the back of the head of Disco. Tell you, the Disco Inferno is down, and Conan really having his way with him. Conan not only has changed his look, but he has really changed his style in the ring. He is more aggressive than ever, but Disco Inferno fires right back with a reverse jawbreaker of his own, and now Disco having some words with Conan and stomping away here. Conan on the receiving end of this here, Brain.
I think what drives me nuts about Disco, he gets a man with Conan's ability down on the mat, and he's walking around fixing his hair, shaking his butt. Don't do that with a man like Conan. Do it with some ham and egger. A man you know you can beat. This man, Conan, can take you out at any given time. You do not waste time with him, or it'll come back to bite you. Mark my words on that.
Scoop slam. Down goes Conan. We recently just celebrated the one-year anniversary of WCW Monday Nitro. And fans, we want to invite you to join us for our second year coming up this Monday, beginning this Monday. Be sure to check your local listings for that two-hour live weekly television at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Conan tumbled through with a big clothesline and a drop kick. That drop kick was on target right in the abdomen that time. Actually hit him in the arm. And Disco goes in. Disco hooks him. See, the man can really go. That's a great counter move.
Wasting a little time there, of course. He's hurt. He's still going to go for it.
Got a two count.
You know, first year anniversary, who knows what the NWO has planned. They love to really show us up and show themselves, show everybody how powerful they are on the first anniversary program of Nitro. You're not kidding. So anything could happen.
That's right. Year number two begins this Monday. Here's a drop kick. And he was on target. He put his teeth in the front row that time.
I like the clothes that Conan's wearing.
I'm sure you do. Ties it up almost like a half grab here. And he's got him with it. And submission hold wins it for the Mexican heavyweight champion Conan. A man who awaits Juventud Guerrero, the young sensation from Mexico. Coming up at Fall Brawl. And back with more on Worldwide from Disney MGM Worldwide Arena after this.
Control Center, and folks, believe it or not, we are only 1 week away from the most talked about event in quite a while. Fall Brawl featuring War Games comes your way next Sunday, September the 15th, available exclusively on pay-per-view. It all begins at 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 out of the West Coast. Call your cable operator right now to ensure availability. Satellite dish owners, contact Turner Premier or DirecTV for sure. As you know by now, WCW will meet the challenge of the New World Order head-on at Fall Brawl. But this is more than just a match. It will be War Games. The double ring, double cage battleground will be center stage for this feud that has gripped professional wrestling. The unlikely team of Lex Luger, Sting, Arn Anderson, and Ric Flair will battle for WCW. The New World Order will counter with Hollywood Hulk Hogan and the Outsiders Hall of Nash. Much has been said about the fourth man of the NWO. Will he show up at War Games? One would think so, but knowing the track record of this NWO, expect anything to happen on September the 15th. Remember, the confines of the double ring steel cage, without a doubt, the most dangerous match in professional wrestling. I don't mind telling you, this has the makings of being the single biggest event in the history of our sport. Now then, in other action for the WCW World Tag Team titles, Harlem Heat with Colonel Parker and Sister Sherry defend against the Nasty Boys. The Giant goes one-on-one against the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and in a match where the only way to win is to force your opponent to submit, Scott Norton meets his former partner, Ice Train. Folks, be part of the action of Fall Brawl and the War Games, available exclusively on pay-per-view. Call your local cable operator right now. Satellite dish owners, contact Turner Premier or DirecTV. By the way, I'm going to have more of this program about Fall Brawl and War Games live Sunday, September 15th.
You know, there's been a lot of talk, Gray. Many people have said that members of the Dungeon of Doom very ticked off, so to speak, that they are not a part of War Games coming up next Sunday, only on pay-per-view. And I've got a little remedy for that. If the Taskmaster's listening, if Jimmy Hart's listening, and the members of the Dungeon of Doom, we're talking about the Giant, Big Bubba, Hugh Morris, if they're listening right now, Hugh Morris getting ready to go to the ring, here's how to solve your problem. If you're mad about not being in War Games, then why don't you go ahead and get in it anyway? The New World Order's going to do something like that. They're going to do something illegal. They're going to do something to stack the odds in their favor. If you're really angry about this New World Order, what they've been doing, then don't talk about it. Do something about it. Take matters in your own hands. And I'm saying, for Luger and Sting, all the horsemen, not just Flair and Arn and the Dungeon of Doom, to get together as a gang and get rid of them.
Well, you know, there's two ways to look at that. I'm sure Hogan and the New World Order are all watching everybody's intensity here. Everybody's mad at each other, but still banding together. This tag team wants in. This guy wants in. This guy wants a part of the NWO. This guy wants a part. They don't realize the hatred they've created here at World Championship Wrestling. And yes, Tony, I would not be surprised if you see more than eight men in that ring. I would not be surprised if you see every big, tough, and not so tough wrestler from WCW get into that cage some way. It's going to be a war, all right. It's going to be something you do not want to miss.
No question about it. The Giant has his own problems, so to speak, as he, of course, the Macho Man Randy Savage will collide. Savage, of course, is a man who's irate right now, blaming the Giant for all the ill wills that have befallen the WCW right now. Hulk Hogan has the gold belt. Hulk Hogan is the world heavyweight champ. And yes, WCW's number one goal is to get that gold belt back. However, we also got to realize that the Macho Man has signed to face Hulk Hogan and Halloween Havoc, our next pay-per-view, on October 27th. But for Savage to look ahead at Hulk Hogan and look past the Giant of the Dungeon of Doom is a mistake, Ray.
No one knows where to look except me. I know exactly what to do. What you do is you don't get into a beef with the Giant. Everybody wants Hogan. Savage is mad at the Giant so much because he wants Hogan. Don't you see, Hogan's the trouble. What you got to do is get rid of Hogan. Get rid of Hogan, like I've said for 20 years. Get rid of Hogan. It's up to Savage now to band with the Giant and the Stings and the Lugers and the Horsemen and everybody to get rid of Hogan. All the trouble here is because of Hulk Hogan.
That's kind of what I was saying at the beginning. You know, they all need to just gang up here.
But not, don't worry about anybody else in the NBA, but you've got to get rid of Hogan. He's the one that's causing all the trouble.
No question. We have seen some crazy things over the past couple of weeks, some unexpected occurrences, like on WCW Monday Nitro a couple of weeks back, the appearance of Ted DiBiase. What is he here for?
Wow.
Only time will tell, as he made a grandiose appearance on WCW Monday Nitro recently. And, of course, showed the fingers four and five. We can only do some speculation about what he was referring to. Maybe the newest member of the Horsemen.
Well, I know he's not from Kentucky, so he's not doing math.
Yeah. Would you please stop? Hugh Moore is one of the most powerful men. Look at that power slam. And he has Max down at ringside as well. Max, certainly a man who's more like a bodyguard for Jimmy Hart.
Look at the distance. Look how far out he is.
He calls this no laughing matter. It is a moonsault. Great extension of the legs that time. One, two, and three. It's over.
Like I said, you give this man some direction. You get him the right manager.
He's dangerous.
Well, there's his manager right there. A little slap of Jimmy Hart there, huh? And there you see Hugh Morris of the Dungeon of Doom.
Never mistake.
Jimmy Hart.
I don't trust you either, Brain.
You trust me?
No, not at all.
I trust you. I'll show you. Give me your credit card.
And there's Max, the bodyguard of Jimmy Hart, members of the Dungeon of Doom, a lethal group in WCW. It's time for our 1-800-COLLECT-REPLAY as we take you to Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Get a load of this. Hugh Morris shoots in Mr. Howard. Good, good power slam. Hugh Morris is such a big man. Well over 325, 30 pounds. I'm not sure what he weighs. Coming off that top rope, moonsault all the way across the ring, finds his target, sits down on Mr. Howard. It's frozen pizza. See you, Leroy.
1-800-COLLECT, the way to save on collect call. Just dial 1-800-COLLECT from any phone to any phone, and you can save. Back with more on Worldwide after this from Disney MGM.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
They're on with the new Laramie Super Soap. XXP275 and 175. Four times the payload of your original Super Soap. New Laramie Super Soap and XXP. Sweater is better!
Dentine Gum. In less than 60 seconds, Dentine's tingly taste will make your breath feel fresh and clean. Brush your breath with Dentine.
When you build a country by hand, you're going to get a little dirty doing it. And for 100 years, Puma's powered lava has been cleaning the hands that make America strong.
World Championship Wrestling presents the Ultimate Battleground without a doubt, and you can go back and check it out in the record books. The single most dangerous match in the history of our sport. More injuries than ever before for 10 solid years. War Games has been known as the way to settle the score. And next Sunday, only on pay-per-view, it'll be the way for WCW to settle the score with Hulk Hogan, Hollywood Hulk Hogan, the Outsiders, Hall and Nash, and whoever this fourth man may be. And you know, I said on Nitro recently, I don't think there's a fourth man. I think there's three. I think they are so arrogant, they are so cocky, that they think they can take on three against four, Brain.
I think along that same lines too. Eric Bischoff mentioned that on Nitro last week. And you know, you think about it, if they were going to have four, they'd have four out here.
Yes, they would.
If they're going to have 30, they'd have 30 out here. That's what I do. I'd show force, I'd show power. Maybe they're just hoping we'll put our tails between our legs and run. I'm not a quitter, Tony.
Nope. I don't know a wrestler yet that's been afraid of a can of spray paint. Prince Iokea is the opponent for Diamond Dallas. Diamond Dallas, quite a story as well. A rags-to-riches story, and a man who now does not officially own that Battle Bowl ring. He lost it to Eddie Guerrero recently, but he left the ring with it and now has it in hiding. He won't come out with it, but Eddie does not have the ring. Eddie won the right to it.
You know what the difference is? Diamond Dallas has the ring, right?
Yeah.
Possession's 9/10 of the law. It's in his vault at home. If Eddie Guerrero had it, it'd be in a pawn shop in El Paso.
You listen to yourself sometime?
But he'd have the big guitar he could play.
And of course, coming up at Fall Brawl, it's going to be really Diamond Dallas against the entire Guerrero family. He will face Chavo Guerrero Jr. in a return match. Eddie, of course, taken out by this man, Diamond Dallas, recently, still mending his wounds. And Chavo Guerrero being strapped recently, of course, by Diamond Dallas as well.
And I took all the Guerrero names the other day and I put them together. It looks like an eye chart.
Diamond Dallas getting out of that. Prince Iokea, a youngster who has made quite a name for himself. Very fluid in the ring, very agile. And a man who has a lot of confidence in a very short career so far in this sport. But Diamond Dallas, with that diamond cutter, has proved to be one of the single most devastating moves in our sport. No doubt about it. And the thing about it is he can hurt his hammer right there. He can put the diamond cutter on anybody at all, Brain, at any time when you least expected it.
You know what I like about Diamond Dallas? The man knows his hole. I saw him put it on Eddie Guerrero from the top rope, the diamond cutter, and level him out.
He knows
what he's doing in there.
Wait a second. The match was over. He had lost the match, and I could see using your hold in the match, but when you put it on a man and you put it on the top rope, you are saying to that man and to the country and the world that you want to take him out of the sport. And that's not the purpose of WCW. The purpose is to win matches and make money.
Well, to me, Tony, a good loser is a loser. You never want to be a good loser. I'll tell you, there's not a clubhouse, a locker room, a dressing room, any place when a team loses, they go in there and sit there and they're happy as can be. No. If you're a winner, then you're a bad loser. That's all I would know.
Put to the solar plexus that time, actually, right around the sternum area. There's drop kick. Iokea showing that fluid move that's made him a budding superstar here in our sport. He is up on top. He has a drop kick. He's on target again. Prince Iokea with level press. One, two, and
no.
The inexperience showing there did not hook the far leg. And it won't be long for this youngster is
right in the cabin, Honolulu.
No, it's moving right up on the ranks. There's your diamond cutter, like we talked about, out of nowhere. Bang is right. One, two, it's academic now. Diamond Dallas is your winner.
That's all it takes.
Diamond Dallas, self high five. He is your winner on Worldwide Wrestling.
Guerrero family, watch that. One mistake, that's all it takes. Self high five.
All right, let's go to the instant replay. That's your turn, Brain. Hello, Brain.
I'll talk when I see the replay.
You're
courtesy of Bobby the Brain Heenan and Diamond Dallas here. Belly to back suplex. Just drops the man on his stomach, the Prince. Shoots him in that rope. Misses with that clothesline, but gets him in the diamond cutter. It's just academic now for the 1, 2, 3. Somebody call a cab?
Oh, would you stop? Our main event is next.
So much for Ponzi Pond.
Folks, once again, we are back here in the control center. It's Fall Brawl, draws ever so close. Only 1 week from this Sunday, this mega event featuring War Games takes the air. And I must say, the excitement is at an all-time high. Join us for this exclusive pay-per-view telecast next Sunday, September the 15th, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 out of the West Coast. You need to call your cable operator right now to ensure availability. Satellite dish owners call Turner Premier or DirecTV. War Games is more than just a match. It is the ultimate battleground. The double ring, the double cage event, the most dangerous match in the history of professional wrestling. This year, survival is more than a goal. It is a necessity as WCW meets the NWO. For the honor of World Championship Wrestling, Lex Luger, Sting, Arn Anderson, and Ric Flair come together for this one night to battle Hollywood Hulk Hogan and the Outsiders Hall and Nash of the New World Order. WCW right now has a one-man advantage, but there is obviously a fourth man for the NWO. Who is he? I would suspect that he's finally going to make his long-awaited appearance at Fall Brawl. Who knows? There could even be a fifth man. In other action, for the WCW Cruiserweight title, Rey Mysterio Jr. defends against arch-rival Super Gallo. Chavo Guerrero Jr. defends family and honor against Diamond Dallas Page. Page recently brutally attacking both Chavo and his cousin Eddie Guerrero. And newcomer Chris Jericho has the task of meeting Chris Benoit of the Four Horsemen. It is so easy to be part of the action of Fall Brawl. Just pick up your telephone and call your local cable operator right now. Satellite dish owners call Turner Premier or DirecTV. This is the one you don't want to miss, fans. Be with us live Sunday, September the 15th, Fall Brawl on pay-per-view.
It is our feature event here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. We want to invite you once again, fans, to make your plans right now. If you, of course, you can call your local cable operator, or if you have DirecTV, or you have the gigantic satellite dish, you can call Turner Premier. You can join us, and you can see WCW make a stand against the NWO, invite the NWO into a battleground that World Championship Wrestling has known for years, War Games.
Nothing tougher, nothing more dangerous. A few people at home that don't have a phone and can't call and don't have a TV, I'm wasting my time talking to you. You don't even know we're on.
The Barbarian and Ming, the Face of Fear, along with Jimmy Hart, members of the Dungeon of Doom as well. And I must say, you know, I'm taking a very, very belligerent attitude towards the NWO, feeling in my heart that I know WCW is going to come through, but in reality, I realize that if history repeats itself, we are going to see some crazy, unexpected things from the New World Order.
No doubt about it. I'll tell you something, Tony. If it was anybody but Hulk Hogan, if there was Hall and Nash, and let's say you or Oakland were involved, I could care less who's going to come in here. I have no allegiance to WCW. I have no allegiance to anybody but myself. But I can't stand Hulk Hogan. So I'll get behind anybody. Well, not Hulk Hogan.
We have to take a break. Back with our main event match after this timeout on Worldwide Wrestling.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by Starburst Fruit Juice. Take a bite, turn up the juice, and enjoy the ride.
Welcome back to Worldwide. Tony Schiavone, Bobby the Brain Heenan, of course, Gene Oakland also with us as Chris Benoit, Arn Anderson of the Horsemen to go against the Face of Fear. And I realize that the Horsemen know the task ahead of them, but I also realize in the back of the mind of Arn Anderson and of Chris Benoit is what happened on Nitro a couple of weeks ago when they were spray-painted, when they were brutally attacked. When, you know, a lot of people have attacked the Horsemen, and they've had fights, they've won fights, they've lost fights. But never in the history of this great sport of WCW have the Horsemen been humiliated. And on Nitro recently, they were humiliated.
If they feel they were humiliated. If that happened to me, I wouldn't feel I was humiliated because nobody can humiliate me. I humiliate myself.
Yes, you do. Well,
I don't, but if I did, I would. But if you... Wait a minute, you've got... What? That's what I'm trying to say.
Go ahead.
You know when you're humiliated.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying.
So if you guys spray paint, you wash the spray paint off, and you go find them in an alley, and you soak a board in motor oil for about 3 weeks, so it won't chip, splinter, or bend. And then when they come out to get in their car, you part their hair. That's what you do. That's humiliation. But I know you. Yeah.
smoke a board in motor oil.
You never did that?
No. Did they do that in Beverly Hills?
No, but I've read about it.
Oh, you've read about it.
West L.A.
You have a more checkered past than you lead on.
I never drove a cab.
A shoulder block, Arn Anderson, the midsection, the barbarian. Arn Anderson, the type of man who will take the fight right to you, regardless of your size. And he took it to the barbarian, and the barbarian takes it right back. One, and the barbarian meets Chris Benoit coming in hard. And there's a close line, and now goes Arn Anderson.
You know, it shows you the toughness of Arn Anderson to take a match with the face of the fear this close to the War Games. I mean, he could get hurt here. He could be out. He could be injured. He's taking his time right now getting back in that ring. Well, when they call him the enforcer, you better say that with capital letters, because this man is just one tough customer.
I really think based on what happened, we are going to see a more aggressive Arn Anderson, a more aggressive Ric Flair.
I got it. I got it.
You've got it?
You know, you're right. With the spray paint and humiliation, they thought the WCW people would just turn their tails and run.
Of course
they did. Because, Tony, right here at Disney, when they attacked him with the ball bats, they could have finished him off just like that. They didn't want to finish him off. They wanted us to take off and embarrass. They wanted to look, anybody could run you out of town and fight your hair with a ball bat, right? They wanted WCW to take off and run, and that's not going to happen.
No, it's not.
So now they'd have brought out their fourth and fifth man, wouldn't they?
Yes.
They don't have anybody but themselves. It's a losing battle.
And that's why they call you the brain.
Boy, remember this. The last time you were home field advantage is when you're being attacked.
Exactly. Here's the cover. One, two. Randy Eller says no, only two that time. Mang, a couple of years in World Championship Wrestling, went from being a bodyguard to one of the most feared men in our sport. And now he and the Barbarian, one of the most successful teams. Chris Benoit with the German suplex from the top. Benoit, of course, on the other hand, known as the Wolverine, Mr. Aggressive, fears no man at all. He has taken on the biggest in our sport.
Look at this. Look at this. You can wear your shoes out on Ming. He won't care.
Look, he just absorbed all those blows in the midsection. He comes right back out and chops Arn Anderson right down.
You were talking how he started out as a bodyguard.
Yep.
Contrary to the story going out that him and the Barbarian sell cosmetics door to door in their off days.
I don't think I don't think that was true. Here we go. Benoit rocked into the corner of the Faces of Fear. Two men who certainly do strike fear in many tag teams, but not certainly the Horsemen. Because as we said, these two men fear no one.
You know who I'd be more afraid of than the Barbarian? His barber.
And goes Benoit. Benoit cross body caught by the Barbarian. Benoit sitting in.
Oh, look at that. And he's giving away 50, 60, 70 pounds.
That's right. And Benoit hooks in the holding for Arn Anderson. Arn Anderson goes to the knees. Here's good strategy. Takes the big power men off their feet because they haven't been able to do much with them up until now.
There's nobody in tag team wrestling better than Arn Anderson. No, it's going to be a Bobby Eaton. But Arn Anderson is tremendous. He knows, he just knows that ring. It's like a second home name. It's like your pocket. You know where the change is. You know where your wallet is. He knows that ring.
Speaking of Bobby Eaton, I'm not so sure after what happened recently on Nitro, is Bobby Eaton going to go by the name Earl Robert Eaton much longer or not? We'll have to keep an eye on that situation. And a tag. And congratulations to a man who's the new World Television Champion, Lord Steven Regal, defeated Lex Luger, but of course with help of the New World Order. And
are you saying Regal could maybe be
I'm not so sure if Regal was behind that or not. I think Regal took advantage of some bad blood.
He told me, I'm going to eventually take advantage of some poor American's mistake.
Look at Ming, if you will. How many people have been able to manhandle Arn Anderson like this throughout his great career?
Not many.
Not many is the answer. You're exactly right.
And the ones that have are now in a wheelchair.
That's Arn Anderson, certainly a man who lives by that enforcer moniker. Into the midsection, and this is where you don't want to be, regardless of who you are. Anyway, Lord Steven Regal, back to that point very quickly. Just Arn's going for the knees here again. It's great strategy to get Ming off his feet as well. He's going on the outside. Regal took advantage of the situation. I think what we saw recently on WCW Saturday night was the fact that the outsiders taking some pre-War Games advantage on one of the members, Lex Luger. Try to get him
all upset.
Let me interject one thing. You notice Arn Anderson pulled Ming out there, and he took his leg. He didn't bang the calf of it into the ring post and slow him down. He banged the ankle into it. That's the difference between the enforcer and your average wrestler. An average wrestler would try to slow a man like Ming down. The enforcer would try to break your leg.
A great point, Bray. Here's a pick up on the arm and with ease. We are seeing the face of fear here have their way with the horsemen, and not many people can say that. I mean, maybe the New World Order can say that, but there's a difference facing them in the ring face to face and jumping them from behind with spray paint and cans and trying to humiliate them. The face of fear doing something that not many people have been able to do.
I wonder if Nick Patrick will be the referee.
You mean War Games?
Yes.
Well, usually the referee...
No, I mean at the Super Bowl.
Well, usually the referee is on the outside and really not that much of an influence. He is just there to call the people in. That's why it's so dangerous. Basically, when they get into that cage, one-on-one, two-on-one, whatever the odds may be, as they come in one at a time, the referee is just there to decide a winner. Now, if Nick Patrick is been paid off by the NWO, that is still up in the air. Maybe he would give the win to the NWO when it's obvious the WCW would win. The only way to find out is to join us on Sunday, September 15th. Find out for yourself. But the referee really just lets them, you know, take care of themselves and win.
But a win one way or the other doesn't mean anything. We've got to get rid of them.
Yeah, that's
true. And that's what they're thinking. They got to get rid of us.
That's true. And that's why War Games is so important.
I mean, everybody knows Hogan gave up before he slapped that figure four on him.
The Clash of the Champions back on the 15th of August. I would agree with that. Can you imagine? I mean, I still have visions.
Can you imagine we agreed on something?
Yes.
Oh!
Now that pile driver was a good one. And Arn Anderson knows it, and he makes the save.
He took his time. He got in. He made sure he had his mark set on the back of the head of Ming. He wasn't going to miss. He was going to make sure he saved his tall horseman.
That was 1 second away from a major upset. As great as the face of fear are, when you defeat the horsemen, it's got to be considered an upset, as hot as they've been in World Championship Wrestling. The Barbarian, fresh off of that pile driver by Ming, wants to end this one right now. And he, I believe, in the direction of Jimmy Hart. No, Ming's going to go up top. They're both going to go up top.
Uh-oh, get an air traffic controller. They're both going for the same runway.
Arn Anderson needs to get in there and pull his man out. Here they go. They are on target. And it's the Barbarian making a cover. One, and Arn Anderson makes the save once again. Twice, Arn Anderson has stopped the feast.
Well, he knows the crippler, Chris Benoit, didn't have the power, didn't have that much left to get out. He's got to get to his knees. He's got to get his wind back. He's got to make the tag. But look at this, the determination. Suplexes the Barbarian.
Benoit rebounding, getting a resurgence here.
Is he tough?
A second or third win. You're not kidding. One of the toughest ever. Oh, my goodness. Ming ended that in flight. Actually, before takeoff. Oh, my goodness.
Rough landing.
Boy, you're not kidding.
Short runway.
Up on top again. The Barbarian throws it three quarters away across.
Give him the gold for that one.
And Arn Anderson is going to DDT.
Oh, at least he won't mess his haircut up.
There you see Randy Eller telling Ming, you better stay here. Arn Anderson, meanwhile, makes his presence known.
Look at this, look at this.
Three.
There's your horseman. There's your horseman in action.
And he cut out Ming, saving the match, preventing the save from Ming. It came right down to the best double-teaming efforts. And you got to give Arn Anderson a lot of credit for what he did in that match. Making the saves, preventing the saves, getting the man down when the back was turned by the referee.
Well, Hogan, get ready. Take a good look. Can you match strength? Can you match power? Can you match width? With the horsemen, I don't think so.
Now here's what's on tap next week on Worldwide. And next week, Bobby the Brain Heenan, the Renegade, and Jim Powers in tag team action.
And a man whose family holds the first subscription to the Wall Street Journal, BK Wall Street, is here.
Cruiserweight champion Rey Mysterio Jr. in singles competition.
And Hugh Morris and Max with two X's and Jimmy Hart take on the lowest form of life here at WCW, the Nasty Boys.
It'll be Fall Brawl weekend. In Brain this week, we have Jim Powers and the Renegade.
And also, we got BK Wall Street here.
That's right, in singles competition. In addition, we have the Cruiserweight champ Rey Mysterio Jr.
And Jimmy Hart presents the Laughing Man, Hugh Morris, and Max with the double X.
In the main event against the Nasty Boys, all coming up next. Tony Schiavone and Bobby the Brain Heenan, welcome to WCW Worldwide.
Worldwide Wrestling. It's Fall Brawl Weekend. The ultimate battleground is set, at least one would think. But bring the reverberations throughout professional wrestling heard, because recently on Nitro, as you see Jim Powers and the Renegade in the opening bout make their way in, the Giant became a full-fledged member of the NWO.
You know, I wonder if he always was a member of the NWO. You know, there's a lot of plotting going on and a lot of behind-the-curtain activities that we're not quite sure of. I don't trust a soul, Tony, not a soul.
You mean to say that when he lost at Hog Wild back in August, that he lost on purpose?
No. I just mean the last couple of weeks. Something could have transpired.
Well, you never know. Ladies and gentlemen, we began with the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Harlem Heat. Two men who this Sunday at Fall Brawl to meet the Nasty Boys for the WCW Tag Team belts.
Or you don't know what their plan was. Because it involved Hogan, right?
Yes, it
and
did.
And Hogan's the man. So, the man. Excuse me.
He's the man of the NWO.
The scum of the NWO.
Sister Sherry leading out the World Tag Team Champions here.
And what's good about Sister Sherry in that outfit, when you get done with dinner, you don't have to squeeze her that much.
In this telecast, as we said, we have VK Wall Street against Beast Brain. Rey Mysterio Jr., the Cruiserweight Champion, is here. John Tenta and Conan. And the Nasty Boys, Hugh Morris and Max. The main event later on in this telecast, and there are the Lovebirds.
Boy, can you see that on top of a wedding cake?
You know, she took quite a bump, if you will, from the Nasty Boys recently on WCW Saturday Night.
And the Colonel's not happy.
No, and that has added, if I can use the old cliche, a lot of fuel to the fire for this upcoming World Tag Team title bout this Sunday at Fall Brawl.
And the Colonel's got a plan. You know, he's buying her gifts. He's showering her with affection. He'd love to hand her the championship belt. Wouldn't you think?
I guess he would. You know, and I have to go back. It wasn't that long ago. You know, we're going to be going back to Las Vegas in October. But it was in January in Las Vegas where Sister Sherry and Colonel Parker, you know, split their ways in that wedding that really never took place.
Wow, that was a rough wedding.
That's putting it mildly. Jim Powers, very powerful man, if I could use that term. Exactly what the name implies. Powers over the top, and look at the spring of the legs.
That's oh!
Stepping on the head, Jim Powers.
Well, you know, not so long ago, Powers and the Renegade, they took it to Dungeon of Doom.
Yes, they did. They are going to be in a short span here, a formidable team in WCW. Arm drag takedown. And what a win it would be for these two men to get a win over the World Tag Team Champs here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Teddy Long there, you saw at ringside.
I've known Jimmy Powers for over 10 years. I don't know him personally, but I know of the man. And he's better now than he ever was. He's quicker, he's faster, he's crisper. And the Renegade is going to learn a lot from Jimmy Powers. They're going to be a heck of a team. The Harlem Heat is just so powerful, so massive. And they got the Colonel and the Sister. I want to go to this wedding. I hope it's in Bucksnort.
I don't even know if there are wedding plans right now or not. But they may be in Oxford, Mississippi.
Oxford, Mississippi?
That's where the Colonel's been living lately.
Well, that's where the big college is, isn't it? Oxford University.
No, that's not where Oxford University is. But, oh, cross body block. One and two. Where famous author John Gresham's from, though. Here's the Renegade trying to get the big guy over. And he does. One and two and
no.
Wow, that was close. Renegade used that bulk of his. No. Oh.
You know, Tony, we have to be very careful, even here at Disney, because you don't know what the NWO is going to do. Look what they did on Nitro the other night, the way they destroyed everything.
Look what they've done on Saturday night recently. Lex Luger lose the world television title.
They're out of control.
To the NWO.
They're totally out of control.
As far as we're concerned, they are. But as far as they're concerned, they're under control.
Well, why don't we do something about it? How can we allow this to happen?
So what do you do? Vertical suplex. The only thing to do is this Sunday, when Lex Luger, Sting, Ric Flair, and Arn Anderson combine forces to get in the cage, and now based on what happened recently on Nitro, Brain, they are together as a unit more solid than ever before.
You know, I thought we'd have trouble with the NWO because they'll do anything. They don't care. Look at they smash all the equipment, thousands and hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of damage, spray paint trucks, beating people with ball bats, threw Eric Bischoff through a petition. I mean, they just don't care. Pretty hard to beat people that just don't care. But I thought as long as we had the Giant on our side, we pretty much had the trump card. But now that the Giant is with them, and we've got Savage, who has stitches in his head, his mind is totally gone. He's been waffled with chairs, and he's going to have to go up against the Giant and then meet Hogan in November. I don't know if he's ready for that task.
Here's the whip in. A clothesline countered him down.
But you're right, we have to stop him this weekend, and we have to stop him by getting Hogan.
Fall Brawl is featuring War Games. War Games, the double ring, double cage event, has been, over the past many years in our sport, the ultimate battleground, the way to settle scores. More people have been injured in War Games than any match in the history of our sport. And ladies and gentlemen, you can join us where the WCW meets the NWO this Sunday, only on pay-per-view.
But you know what I'm really scared of? War Games was designed for who?
Four horsemen.
The four horsemen. But there's only two horsemen in there.
Yeah.
They're going to rely on Sting and Luger. Can those four get along together against the NWO? They're going to have to survive. If they don't, it's going to be the NWO against the horsemen and against Sting and Luger. It's going to be three different factions in there.
Up on the middle turnbuckle is Booker T. And he missed that time. You know, I would wonder about that too. But in light of what happened, and we're going to show you the footage later on in this telecast, fans, I think they will put their differences behind them, will those men, and represent WCW now more than ever before. Renegade gets the tag. Here's Renegade in against the World Tag Team Champs and the big powerful man. They're in house here of the World Tag Team Champs.
He's doing that. He has an energy level of about, 6 million.
Power slam down Stevie Ray Booker T, lingering in the ring and to the advantage now of Harlem Heat as he gets the save. Keep in mind, the two men you're looking at right now, not the legal man, dumped on the outside, Jim Powers.
And look where he's dumped, right at the feet of the Colonel.
Well, that's trouble.
This could be a three-pointer.
And it's more trouble even that Sherry
is
overdoing.
She's helping him up. She's helping him up.
Oh, she kneed him in the face. And down goes the Renegade. One, two, three. Nothing funny about that.
Did Sherry ever knee you in the face?
No.
I may ask her. Maybe she will.
No, I'd rather not.
I don't care.
Teddy Long over to help up Jim Powers. Sherry.
Come on, Teddy Long. Put your head down and run towards the Colonel. He'll hit your head with that cane. You'll think Mark McGuire hit you.
Winners, World Tag Team Champs, Harlem Heat, and they now await the Nasty Boys this Sunday.
No doubt about that. Sherry, having to be restrained as usual. The Colonel means business. Everybody get ready. War Games is coming this Sunday. Hit him, Colonel. Hit him.
Still to come, fans, in this telecast, the Nasty Boys in our main event against members of the Dungeon of Doom. Plus, we will take you back recently on WCW Monday Nitro. The Giant becomes a member of the NWO. That's startling footage. War Games Fall Brawl is this Sunday. We know the Giant's a part of the NWO. It is still, though, unclear, though, who will be the fourth man at War Games for the NWO. The Giant already in a match against the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Tony, it does not look good for us. And I'll tell you why it don't look good for us. Our hope of surviving a WCW here was on Savage's shoulders. You know how badly Savage is beaten up now. I always thought the NWO posed a problem. They were very dangerous people, but I knew in our back pocket we had the Giant, the biggest athlete in professional sports. Now that he's gone with them, we're sending a busted up, mentally deficient Randy Macho Man Savage into the ring to save our careers. What is going to happen?
We're also sending Sting, Lex Luger, Ric Flair, and Arn Anderson in the cage at War Games. We'll show you the footage from Nitro later on, but right now, fans, back with more Worldwide after this.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by Pep Boys. 26,000 items at a guaranteed low price. Tires and service, too. Everything but gas. Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Dentine gum. In less than 60 seconds, Dentine's tingly taste will make your breath feel fresh and clean. Brush your breath with Dentine.
Coming Friday the 13th, the showdown is on. From dusk till dawn on pay-per-view.
When you build a country by hand, you're going to get a little dirty doing it. And for 100 years, pumice-powered lava has been cleaning the hands that make America strong.
Hi, gang. Gene Okerlund here in the control center on this Fall Brawl weekend. This Sunday, Fall Brawl featuring the War Games takes the air. The event, exclusively on pay-per-view, begins at 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 on the West Coast. Call your cable operator right now to ensure availability. WCW will meet the challenge of the NWO head-on at Fall Brawl and War Games. Double ring, double cage, that's the battleground. That's going to be center stage for this feud that has gripped all of professional wrestling. Anderson and Ric Flair will battle for WCW. The New World Order will counter with Hulk Hogan and the Outsiders, Hall and Nash. And remember the confines of that double ring steel cage, without a doubt the most dangerous match in professional wrestling. In addition, the Giant now being part of the NWO, his match against the Macho Man, Randy Savage, at Fall Brawl takes on a whole new meaning. Savage has Hogan in October. The Giant would like to stop him at Fall Brawl. Also, WCW tag team title holders, the Harlem Heat, Colonel Parker's sister Sherry with them, to defend against the Nasty Boys. And in a match where the only way to win is to force your opponent to submit, Scott Norton meets his former partner, Ice Train. It's so easy to be part of the action. Call your local cable operator right now. Satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier at 1-800-843-9266 or DirecTV at 1-800-347-3288. I'm going to be back with more later in this program about Fall Brawl. It all happens this Sunday, exclusively on pay-per-view. Don't go away.
Fall Brawl is the one. It's the event that we are waiting for because we are World Championship Wrestling. It's the event every year that settles the score between athletes in WCW. But this year, it's not going to settle a difference between athletes in WCW. It's going to settle the difference between athletes of two separate organizations, World Championship Wrestling and the New World Order. As VK Wall Street makes his way to the ring, Brain.
He's my stockbroker.
He is?
Yes. Gives me a lot of great tips. A lot of people don't even know about them.
VK Wall Street in this one-on-one matchup to go up against Ice Train. This stockbroker, as Brain says, quite a wrestler as well. VK Wall Street, over the years, known as one of the great scientific grapplers in the world, but a man who has been known to break the rules, and that has always befuddled me, so to speak. A man with VK Wall Street's ability and credentials to do the things that he does. And going up now against Ice Train with Teddy Long here in this one-on-one matchup on Worldwide.
You know, let me tell you something about Teddy Long. Hey, it's Gladys Knight.
You stop. Go ahead.
I don't want to tell you nothing about Teddy Long. Decided not to.
Okay, thank you for nothing.
Don't mention it.
Ice Train, all right, let's say this. Ice Train seems to be on the mend since the injury suffered at the hands of the Giant. And Ice Train looking for a lot of payback this Sunday as he faces his old partner, Scott Norton, in a submission match where the only way to win is to get your opponent to give up.
Well, I can't see Scott Norton giving up. Then again, I can't see this guy giving up.
I think the underlying factor is the fact is that he's had an injured shoulder,
mm-hmm.
and Norton's going to work on that.
Of course he is. And you talk about Wall Street. Some of the things he did, maybe you don't approve of. Maybe you think he cheats. Nobody gets to be good at anything in Wall Street or in the money business unless you cheat a little bit.
I don't believe that. You're trying to say that an honest man cannot get ahead in this world?
Oh, yes, he can get ahead. Just takes some longer.
A clothesline down goes Ice Train. Not many people can say they have clotheslined Ice Train down, but basically, he is hitting Ice Train with everything he can, and I'm not so sure this is the right strategy. A big, strapping man like Ice Train, take him off his feet.
See, what I would do now is, if I was VK, I'd go and have a meeting with Scott Norton and say, how much is it worth to you for me to get in the ring and hurt this guy's shoulder?
Maybe he's done it already.
Maybe he has. As smart as VK is, I'm sure he has. But that's what I do, is I'd work on that injured shoulder. And he's not doing it, so that's why I don't think the deal was set.
Mm-hmm. So side headlock.
See what I mean, though?
I see what you mean.
Pick yourself up a few extra bucks here in the ring. It's a tough world now.
Nice Train sitting down. Good move by the big, powerful man. Sitting VK Wall Street down, and there you see Nick Patrick, the referee, assigned to this one. And the ropes, a reversal, Ice Train in, no sir. He moves,
oh!
A big splash. Two, three.
He got him.
Ice Train is your winner.
Bad shoulder and all.
That was awesome. Ice Train awaits now. His partner, Scott Flash Norton, as Fire and Ice will collide this Sunday as part of Fall Brawl, leading up to War Games
the match beyond.
And for this man's young career ice train to pull off a victory over VK Wall Street here on Worldwide is very, very impressive. A lot of people are going to be looking at him. Shoots VK off into the ropes. Good leapfrog from a big man. Big, powerful hip lock. I don't have to tell you humanoids to see all that. That's called a body slam, dummy.
Dummy?
You talking to me?
No, I just was...
Talking to yourself.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, does he land on him? For the 1-2-3, very impressive win for Ice Train over VK Wall Street.
Thank you, Brain.
Don't mention it,
Coming
Tony.
Coming up next, the Cruiserweight Champ. In addition, we will take you back to Nitro. You are not going to believe what you're going to see from the Giants. All coming up next on Worldwide Wrestling. Back on Worldwide, and before we go to the ring, we're going to take you back to WCW Monday Nitro. Take a look at this footage. The Giant becomes a member of the NWO and then destroys Nitro. Ladies and gentlemen, the Giant, part of the NWO. Ted DiBiase, apparently a part of the NWO.
But well, he's not getting in that car for nothing.
You know, and I need to say this. When Fall Brawl hits the airwave this coming Sunday, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, we still do not know who the NWO will have as its fourth man. Hulk Hogan said, 5, 6, 7. There's more plans for more people. The Giants already wrestling. We talked about it earlier. The Giants wrestling the Macho Man Randy Savage. I don't think the Giant's going to be in the cage. I don't think he'll wrestle twice.
You don't know, though. Are they going to wait till bell time to surprise us on us?
I think they will.
You know, and I bet only 3 will show up, and you'll see the other 4, 5, or 6 later on down the line that evening. I mean, you don't know. Now you got humanoid fans carrying NWO signs.
You know, well, I would agree with you on that one.
That means a no wrestling organization. They haven't shown any wrestling. They're good with ball bats and throwing people in the trailers and spray paint stuff.
That's right.
Looks like an alien. Look at him.
Well, he is a wrestler. He is the Cruiserweight Champion of the World, Rey Mysterio Jr.
But look at the hair, Konami. You sure that's not Demi Moore?
Yes, I'm sure.
She's a lot prettier.
Yes, she is. And a lot bigger.
More attractive.
Yes, she is. Okay, here we go. Rey Mysterio Jr. and Pat Tanaka. Rey Mysterio Jr. to face one of his real archenemies in Super Callow in a match that will come your way at Fall Brawl this Sunday for the Cruiserweight Championship. Super Callow, by the way, will make his worldwide debut, we understand, next week. But Rey Mysterio Jr. is a man who is ruling the Cruiserweight scene and a man who I really think, based on the way he can perform in the ring, is really, and all the athletes go into this, but he's the centerpiece making this Cruiserweight division what it is, so I'm so excited.
I think he's going to set the standard for the year 2000. I think his ability in the ring, the things he does, the young people coming up are going to copy this man, and you're going to see more people doing this stuff. Not as good, maybe, but they're going to try. And this Pat Tanaka, oh!
The high-risk maneuver.
This Pat Tanaka can take you out.
Yes, he can, from Rey Mysterio Jr., the young man, we understand, in his early 20s, but the man who wrestles like a veteran. And he hurt him. This is why it's a high-risk maneuver. You can hurt yourself as well as your opponent, but he's back in the ring.
He hurt himself. Look what he goes for. No!
He went for a flying head scissors, and Tanaka turned it into an awesome power bomb.
Wow! See, don't ever sell this Pat Tanaka short.
That's right.
Second generation, his father, the great Duke Kiyomuka, master of the claw hold.
Into the corner, into the ropes, and a pickup spins him.
Oh!
Mysterio landed on his feet, but then paid the price from Pat Tanaka.
Don't waste your time with him, Mr. Tanaka. Kick his head off.
Wow. A sidekick. 1, 2, and Mysterio gets out.
Everybody's talking about Nick Patrick. That was a slow count there.
Randy Eller, but it's a consistent count.
So if he's consistently bad, we go along with it instead of dumping him.
Well, yes, you do.
No, you don't. You hire better officials.
Rey Mysterio with a Frankenstein.
He got him.
Middle one, and a 2, and a 3. Oh, my goodness.
Boy, did he have him wrapped up. But he's hurt Mysterio Jr.
Yes, he is. The weekend of Fall Brawl, Rey Mysterio Jr. reached again. And this is going to be our Pimp Boys Power Pin of the Week. Well, they love him, don't they? They're excited about the Cruiserweight Champ of the World. Let's take a look at the Power Pin, Brain.
Glad to. You know, Mysterio is so fast, so agile. He's very hard to beat. And he's wounded here, and he still comes off that top rope on Tanaka. Looks like he may have jammed an ankle there or a knee. Look at this. Tanaka just has nothing he can do about it. He's just in deep, deep trouble.
Pep Boys, America's Automotive Supercenter, bringing you the Power Pin of the Week. Back with more on Worldwide after this timeout.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Dentine gum. In less than 60 seconds, Dentine's tingly taste will make your breath feel fresh and clean. Brush your breath with Dentine. Unlike any cream, Absorbine Junior has a unique penetrating ingredient for liquid fast relief. Ah, Absorbine.
At Rent-A-Center, you can try it before you buy it, so you never get stuck with anything you don't want. We guarantee it. Call 1-800-546-4900 now to find out how.
Pete Arkin is back once again here in the control center on this Fall Brawl weekend. This Sunday evening, Fall Brawl featuring the War Games takes the air, and I must say this past week has been nothing less than a shocker. This exclusive pay-per-view telecast will be held this Sunday, 7 o'clock Eastern. Call your cable operator right now to ensure availability. War Games is more than just a match. It is the ultimate battleground, the double ring, double cage event, the most dangerous match in our sport. But now, how about the Giant becoming a part of the New World Order? Will he be the fourth man in War Games? At this, the 11th hour, we are still not sure. And add to that, the presence of Ted DiBiase, day by day, the NWO, is getting more powerful. In War Games, the honor of WCW to be represented by Luger, Sting, Anderson, and Flair. They are together as they battle Hulk Hogan and the Outsiders, Hall and Nash. Hogan's talked about a fifth or sixth man still to come. Who else will join the NWO? Only Fall Brawl will reveal that answer. As we said earlier, the Giant, the latest turncoat, to battle the Macho Man, Randy Savage. That match now has even more significance. In addition, for the WCW Cruiserweight title, Rey Mysterio Jr. to defend against arch-rival Super Calo. Chavo Guerrero Jr. meets Diamond Dallas Page. Conan now defends his Mexican heavyweight title against Juventud Guerrera. Psychosis sidelined with a broken arm, thanks to Conan. And newcomer Chris Jericho faces Chris Benoit of the Four Horsemen. It is so easy to be part of all of the action of Fall Brawl. Just pick up the telephone, call your local cable operator right now. Satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier at 1-800-843-9266 or DirecTV at 1-800-347-3288. This is the one you don't want to miss. It all happens this Sunday at 7 o'clock Eastern. Get ready for Fall Brawl and the War Games.
World Championship Wrestling Fall Brawl, the weekend is here. This is the one you want to see. If you want to see WCW's time to get revenge, to pay back the NWO, WCW two ring double cage, the ultimate battleground is this Sunday. Call right now, don't be left out. Only on pay-per-view, 7 o'clock Eastern time, Brain.
And this is make it or break it for the NWO, not for us. Because we're WCW, and we've made it. For them to make it, they got to break us. And I don't think they can do it.
John Tenta makes his way to the ring as we are set to go with this match on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Good to have you with us wherever you are. We'll let our fans know that tickets are still on sale all the way up till bell time, we understand. Winston-Salem, North Carolina, the Blanchfield Coliseum for this Sunday's pay-per-view event. And don't forget, our next pay-per-view event is going to be in Las Vegas at the MGM Grand. It will be Halloween Havoc coming your way the 27th of October.
Well, Conan certainly has a new look, don't he?
And a new attitude to boot. Now, let's bring the fans up to speed. As you've heard it, Gene Okerlund talk about many times, Conan will now face Juventud Guerrera, another one of the tremendous... Juventud Guerrera, number one of the great wrestlers from the AAA promotion down in Mexico, because Psychosis cannot wrestle Conan the Mexican heavyweight title as earlier planned at Fall Brawl. The reason? Conan recently broke the arm of Psychosis.
He's going to have his hands full here with Big John Tenta, over 500 pounds.
And he's wasting no time.
Half man, half Ben Franklin.
Half man, half Ben Franklin.
Look at Tenta from one side.
Okay, I understand.
There you go.
All right.
Like he could be on the front and the back of a dollar bill.
Yes, he could be anywhere he wanted to be.
You bet.
And right now, he is very angry, and he is pounding Conan down to the mat.
He's dribbling him.
Oh, look at this. And those are massive shots from this 500-pound man, John Tenta.
Oh.
Imagine being caught in there. And absolutely no place to go. Snap Mary Lover steps on him.
On his heart. He stood on the man's heart.
On the start. Oh. Oh, my. That'll change your attitude. This is a man, if he can get the weight, if he can get you down on the mat, he'll beat you. And he's got an elbow drop, and he may be one more move away from defeating Conan here. The Mexican heavyweight champ, there's a leg drop.
Conan's got to get by the ropes or get out of the ring, because he's not going to be able to push Big Ten off him if he covers him. Ah, he's not covering him good.
Two count, you're
going to lay that weight on him.
Absolutely. Put all 500-plus pounds on top, press the shoulders down. You tell him, Coach Heenan. Back in the corner.
Can't help it, I'm right all the time. I've been cursed with it all my life.
You're right some of the time. The other things you just make up, but that's okay.
I'll make things up.
Of course you do. And John Tenta showing his agility. And Conan, who came into this match.
He's showing his Calvin Klein.
Yeah, very aggressive here. Is much the different now. He tries to the midsection.
Why do people buy underwear bigger than their pants? Never made sense to me.
Well,
they wear them over their pants then.
I've never taken an underwear poll. I don't know. And down goes Conan. Maybe we should stand outside the arena. Excuse me, sir. Could I ask you about your... No, forget it. John Tenta stalking Conan now.
Well, Winston Salem, you're going to be hearing a lot of people say, what's that?
Stop. We have tremendous fans in Winston Salem, North Carolina.
You put them on one leg
with
the team.
Stop it. Conan goes right into the big guy. This could end the match right now. Power slam. But did not cover it. John Denton.
He had him.
He has other plans for Conan. And oh, my goodness.
Second floor.
If he connects, this one's over. As a matter of fact, if he connects, Conan may not make it to fall brawl.
And if he misses, we'll think Gallagher's been here. Oh!
He didn't miss. And now Conan is up on top himself. What's he got in mind for the big 500-pound guy?
I don't think Tenta was ready for that.
Somersaults off one, two, three, and beats John Tenta.
See, John Tenta thought he was going to come off and was going to catch him in a bear hug. He didn't think Conan would somersault and land on him. That knocked the starch on him. He hit the back of his head when he hit the mat. There's your winner, Conan.
Conan is your winner, and the new attitude serves him quite well. He awaits his arrow.
The dungeon's coming for you.
For the Mexican heavyweight title this Sunday at Fall Brawl, our main event next on Worldwide Wrestling. Stay right where you are.
Moving to.
Your opportunity to join us exclusively on pay-per-view is rapidly approaching. This Sunday, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, World Championship Wrestling presents Fall Brawl. And of all the matches, Brain, that I'm most concerned about, I've talked a lot about war games. The Macho Man Randy Savage and the Giant will collide one-on-one. We know about that match. We've talked about it before, but never like we've talked about it this week. Because now, as the Macho Man must think ahead, and he must, because he and Hogan will battle at Halloween Havoc in October in Las Vegas. Even more emphasis now in that match because you know and I know the Giant will be there to protect the interests of the NWO. He will be there to end the career of the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and to prevent him from going to Halloween Havoc.
He's
going to
break his back in Winston-Salem. Savage will be sent to the hospital that night. There's no way Savage, after what he has sustained lately, is going to laugh in that ring. He'll go in there and fight 200%. He's got guts. There's no doubt about that. He won't quit. They'll have to take him out of there in a bag. He'll fight all night, but the Giant will prevail because there's no way Savage is going to get through that man and then make it to Halloween Havoc and win the title from Hogan. It just can't be done. He's human. He's a human being. And here come two guys, when you step on their foot, they open their mouth like trash cans.
Well, that
says it all, don't it?
Says it all. It's a pretty good description. Wait a minute. I'm not going to talk about them like that. You lead me into these things. The Nasty Boys certainly made their presence known over and over again to Harlem Heat. They have the upper hand, but this Sunday, they must vie for the World Tag Team title. They will face Hugh Morris and Max of the Dungeon of Doom with Jimmy Hart in our main event. After this on Worldwide.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by Pep Boys. 26,000 items at a guaranteed low price. Tires and service too. Everything but gas.
Welcome back, fans, for the main event on Worldwide Wrestling.
Wait a minute. I want to ask the people something.
All right, what?
How do they smell?
Oh.
See, they agree with me.
It's our main event on Worldwide Wrestling, and they must face Max and Hugh Morris. And, you know, Max, Hugh Morris, the entire Dungeon of Doom embroiled in what has happened with the NWO. Not on a personal level, but that eight-man tag, we saw the footage earlier. There is no question that the NWO is getting stronger day by day in in professional wrestling, I should say.
You know, Tony, I've always thought we had a chance because we had the Giant. I thought as long as we got that man, we've got the battleship. We've got the big B-25. We've got the atomic hydrogen bomb.
B-25.
We don't have that anymore.
No, we don't.
We don't have that anymore. We have a man whose mind is totally shattered. A man who should be taking shock treatments and be locked in a padded room, Savage. A very, very dangerous man going up against the Giant.
The chant of Nasty for the fans of the Nasty Boys. This Max, one of the most powerful men in our sport. If you'll look at that upper body, you'll see what I mean. And those arms and that chest. But remember, he is in against one of the classic brawlers in Jerry Sags in our sport. And a man... two things actually about the Nasty Boys, they can brawl, but they can take a beating. I mean, I've seen them hit with trash cans and tables and everything, and they just keep coming at you. They don't know when to stop.
Well, you don't understand. You know, you take a guy like Bob Hartley, Bob Newhart, and you hit him with a trash can, it's over. They get hit with trash cans every day. This is their life. They like it. They like to fight. They like to be beat on. They like to walk down alleys with $20 hanging out of their pocket. They get to the end of the alley, they got $50. I mean, they're that kind of people. Look at this. Look at this.
It's Braun, and he's out. The member of the Dungeon of Doom chasing one of our crew members here, chasing Jimmy Hart, and all of a sudden back out of the arena.
He's making good time.
Boy, is he ever. Braun is as wild as they come. A part of the Dungeon of Doom. He has made his presence known over the past couple of weeks here on Worldwide and on many of our television programs on the WCW Network.
You know, you can't be a member of the Dungeon of Doom unless you've done some serious time in a mental institution.
I would agree with that. And, of course, the former member of the Dungeon of Doom, the Giant, has left everyone in his wake, including members of the Faces of Fear, the Taskmaster, Big Bubba. And right now, Hugh Morris. Hugh Morris, and I really think this brain of all the members of the Dungeon of Doom may be the most underrated. Here's a guy who is strong, who is quick.
Agile.
He just has this...
focus problem.
This focus problem.
He needs a manager.
He likes to laugh.
Yeah. Well, I like to laugh, too. But I laugh at other people's expense. I make people look bad. I make fun of people. That's how I enjoy myself.
Yeah, well, you're a nice
guy.
But
they make fun of themselves, too. So that's why I do it.
Foot to the face.
Oh!
Knobs returns fire. Here's lateral press. One and two and new. Max. Stop that one cold, and now Knobs taking Hugh Morris into the corner, and here it is. This is known as clubbering. Not clubbering, but clubbering.
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 Spell that.
See you.
Later.
Wait a minute, C-L-U. Forget it. In the corner.
Obviously, you've been taking the Dusty Rhodes course again in public speaking.
Yes. McPatrick down to make the 1-2. A count only that time.
Of course, you'd talk like that, too, if you ate three bales of hay a day.
And Jerry Sags down as Brian Knobs takes care of Max. Here goes Sags. Look at this.
Now, see, he touched the referee by accident there. He just put his arms up, and the referee got in the middle. Nick Patrick would disqualify him for that.
Nick Patrick sending back to the corner. Meanwhile, posted...
So how come
Knobs.
He disqualified Luger
well,
the other night?
I don't want to get into this bickering session, but I think Nick Patrick actually grabbed the man instead of the man bumping him.
Well, you know, he's been under the microscope so much, he's paranoid now.
Well, with the exception of Nick not getting that limousine recently on Nitro, I really think he's a full-fledged plant of the NWO.
Oh, you think he's on their...
I think money
on
talks.
On the take.
I think money talks. I think if they had enough money in their bank account, they could... influence someone else in our broadcast team, if you know what I mean.
Well, I always knew Oakland was that kind of a guy.
Moonsault 1-2, double axe handle blow.
What kind of money are you talking? I mean, what kind of money are they throwing out?
I don't know. Why don't
hypothetically, I'd like to. Why don't you
investigate this?
I will have nothing to do with
them. Why don't you and VK Wall Street talk about some more investments? Here comes the moonsault again.
Oh!
Nobody home for that one. He tried one too many times that time.
Well, if you get a fresh nasty in here, which is a very strange thing to happen, you don't find many nasties that are fresh.
Tag, Max is in. Jerry Sags meets him, and Max gets the first blow in, and there's a back elbow, side of the head. Jerry Sags sending Max back. Here he comes.
Oh!
Whoa!
Max, you're right.
I think his head landed in someone's living room that time.
In Warren, Pennsylvania.
Look at this, a pickup. Showing the power of Sags. Power slams him down virtually. One, two, and a save by Hugh Morris and Brian Knobs. These two men trying to make a statement as we head to Fall Brawl this Sunday. They want to be World Tag Team Champs. Into the big full Nelson. That's Max's big move. He's got it on. Brian Knobs from behind. Double axe handle on the back of the head, and that's stunned him. The double team. The schoolboy combination clothesline. One, two, three. It wins it for the Nasty Boys.
And they did it with teamwork.
How about that?
They had to be just lucky.
The Nasty Boys are going to need teamwork this Sunday at Fall Brawl if they want to recapture the tag team glory of World Championship Wrestling. We are taking a good look. Thank you very much.
All the way down your stinking throat.
Oh, shut up.
Thank you, Brain, for saying that for me. And your winner?
Shut up. That's for me, too.
Okay, there you go.
Shut up. That's for both of us. How do you like that? But they won't shut up. They're nasty. You got Hugh Morris in the corner with no place to go. Knob comes in at over 100 miles an hour, I bet, and just waffles him. Hugh Morris comes off that top, and there's nobody home. Getting up very slowly. Now, Max has Sags in the full Nelson, but didn't know that Knob came up behind him. Now, watch this. Kind of like a club sandwich. One hits you high, one hits you low.
Wow.
And that's just about it for Max. For the 1-2-3, Nick Patrick is in position. He's doing his job as far as I'm concerned. But then again, sometimes you just don't know. You just don't know what's going on here at World Championship Wrestling. It's a mess.
Be sure to join us next week right here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. Next week, debut by Juventud Guerrera on Worldwide, as well as Super Calo from Mexico, Brain.
And Diamond Dallas Page takes on the Fred Astaire of WCW, the Denny Terrio, Disco Inferno.
Rock and Roll Express in the main event in tag team action against Chris Benoit and Arn Anderson of the Four Horsemen. Be sure to check your local listings for the time of WCW Worldwide Wrestling coming your way next week. Fans, you still have an opportunity to join us this Sunday exclusively on pay-per-view. If you're watching this after Sunday night, you can join us on the encore presentation. Be sure to check your local listings for the time of WCW's Fall Brawl featuring War Games, Brain.
Let me show you what this world has come to right now. You remember who this man is? I got this out of a video store the other day. This is the old Hulk Hogan. You see what's happening? All his fans, the kids, they're ripping the arms off. They have no respect anymore for this man. Well, I'll tell you something, Hogan. When you step in that cage, NWO against WCW, you better grow another arm because they're going to tear both arms off you. You're a disgrace to our sport. You're a disgrace to walk this earth.
You tell him, Brain. For the Brain up next, the sensational Juventud Guerrera.
And Diamond Dallas Page takes on the hottest beat in wrestling, Disco Inferno.
From Mexico, it's Super Calo.
And a big eight-man tag. That's right, eight-man tag with the Dungeon of Doom.
The main event, the Rock and Roll Express, going up against members of the Four Horsemen. All coming up next on Worldwide Wrestling.
Tony Schiavone along with Bobby the Brain Heenan, and welcome to WCW Worldwide Wrestling from the Worldwide Arena at the Disney MGM Studios in Orlando, Florida. Good to have you with us here in the month of September. You know, we're in the month of September as Jerry Lynn makes his way in for the opening bout, Brain, but all eyes of the wrestling world, as the old cliche goes, is focusing on the month of October, because that's when Halloween Havoc comes our way. This year, Slim Jim's presents Halloween Havoc. It's going to be bigger than ever.
Well, Savage is going after Hogan, and he's going after Hogan full force, straight on. And Hogan's been hiding behind a lot of people lately.
Let's see what they come up with at Halloween Havoc.
As you said, Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage for the WCW World Heavyweight Championship.
Wait a minute.
What?
I feel like I'm at a bullfight.
It's Juventud Guerrera making his debut on Worldwide Wrestling.
You know what Juventud means in Spanish?
Yes, I do.
It means my sombrero's too tight.
No, it means young. Juventud Guerrera means...
Young sombreros.
No,
I get,
no,
yeah,
no, it
the
means,
bands don't, they don't bend.
No, it means young warrior.
Oh.
He's a tremendous second generation superstar from Mexico in the AAA promotion there. We have seen him on WCW Monday Nitro. We have seen him on countless pay-per-view telecasts, but right now, his debut against Jerry Lynn here on Worldwide Wrestling.
Juventud often also sounds like something a plumber'd use.
Yeah, sure it does. Drives him down to one knee. Jerry Lynn, a great competitor, known not only here in the United States, but in Japan as well, in Europe. And Jerry Lynn snaps him over the snapmare. The nip up that time and an arm drag takedown. Look at this. Look at the athletic ability of Juventud, but also a little bit of a showman as well.
Now, Juve here, he's not related to the Guerreros, is he?
No, it's Guerrera, and they are the Guerreros. Ah, no.
So he's an A and they're an O.
Well, that's just the way you pronounce their name. Let's not get into that. From the neutral position, a full arm drag and twist executed in this telecast. As we said, tremendous main event. Rock and Roll Express and tag team action. They're the former tag team champs against Arn Anderson, Chris Benoit.
Now look at the tights on Hoovy here and the long hair. Are you sure he wasn't a member of KISS at one time?
I'm sure he wasn't. As a matter of fact, if he's a member of KISS, he'd be on some tour right now.
Or 77 years old.
No, they're not that old. Would you stop? Arm drag takedown, nicely done. And by the way, his name is Juventud, not Hoovy. Not Hoovy.
Hoovy.
Juventud.
You know what Hoovy means in Spanish?
What?
Sombrero's really getting small.
Okay.
Oh!
Oh, boy. A chop to Jerry Lynn in the corner. Nick Patrick is the referee, and Jerry Lynn returns fire back now to Juventud. A reversal. Guerrera sends him in. Jerry Lynn up on top. Cross body. Rolled through that time. Didn't get a pin. A leapfrog. Some quick action going on the opening bout here. Hits
Whoa.
A good takedown.
Well, you talk about the cruiserweight division here at WCW. It's faster and it's tougher than I think it's ever been. Any place in the world.
Well, you're talking about the cruiserweight division. You've got to say, first of all, that Rey Mysterio Jr. is the champion. Juventud Guerrera, one of the top contenders. Super Callow. We've got the...
Eddie Guerrero.
Dean Malenko, the former champion. Brad Armstrong.
JL.
Jerry Lynn here. Many great superstars from Japan. Otani. Former champion as well.
And it is Jushin Thunder Liger.
Jushin Thunder Liger, who is, we understand, still very, very ill. Not competing right now, but a very top superstar in our sport. Hopefully he'll be able to get back in the ring very soon.
Ooh.
Backhanded chop. Missed.
Oh!
Spinning back kick that time. It's nicely done. Guerrera.
We're wasting a little too much time here.
He's another man we didn't mention, Chavo Guerrero Jr.
I had a reason for not mentioning him.
Why was that?
I don't like him.
Well, that shouldn't stop you from mentioning his name. He's a top contender.
You're right. There is a way to mention
it. Oh, look at that. Jerry Lynn ducked the foot that time and could not duck the clothesline at all.
There is a way to mention him, even if you don't like him. You're right.
How is that?
And there is that great wrestler, Chavo Guerrero. But I hate his whole family.
What?
Can I say something like that?
No.
Never mind.
Whatever you want. Up on top.
Oh!
A somersault, and the feet came right down on the face of Jerry Lynn. You know, we are seeing, and we have seen from the likes of Rey Mysterio Jr., Juventud Guerrera, even a man we're going to see later on, Super Callow, a new brand of wrestling that they brought to this cruiserweight division. High-flying, high-risk maneuvers, but also revolutionary moves. I think they really improvise as they go a lot of times.
You know, I'll tell you, another man everyone's talking about is Glacier, who is not a cruiser. He's a heavyweight. But everyone's talking about this man. He has moves that's going to revolutionize wrestling in the 90s, in the millennium.
Well, there's no question about it that Glacier brings a whole new style to World Championship Wrestling. And I understand, will be seeing Glacier in the weeks to come. Very, very soon right here on Worldwide.
Well, WCW brings a whole new style to wrestling.
Boy, does it ever.
Oh!
One, two, with the German suplex. Gets a two count that time. Both men hit very hard.
Well, I thought he had Hoovy on that one.
Juventud, that'll slow you down.
You don't know him as well as I do.
Apparently not. Waist lock, back elbow, got him out of that. And a pickup that was almost like a crucifix and a combination side salto that time. Here's Juventud Guerrera. Lateral press, no. He's going to pull him out towards the center of the ring. Good strategy this time. One, two, but Jerry Lynn is on the rope.
Where's Juve from?
Juventud is from Mexico. Haven't I said
any particular place? I mean,
haven't I said that many times?
They just drove around when he was born the whole day. I mean, where in Mexico?
Down he goes.
Going narrow it down.
An elbow drop.
Any place particular? Maybe San Antonio, L.A., Houston. Where?
A punt.
Oh!
Oh, what a leg drop and using the top rope.
Mexico City. I mean,
Tijuana.
Where?
Two and gets a two count.
I'm a broadcast journalist. If I know his home and his city he's from, I can do a little in-depth study on the man.
In other words, you can make things up about him is what you can do. Yes, you can. Here's a scoop slam.
Make things up about a man. That would be unethical.
Yeah, but it would be just like you. Up on the top, and once again, he tried it earlier, but Jerry Lynn is too quick that time. He stepped out of the way, and now Jerry Lynn.
I think Hoovy's setting him up, though.
Juventud barely getting to his feet. Jerry Lynn connects.
No. Hoovy's out in his feet.
A thrust kick from the top of the one, two, and three.
No.
Did not get him, says Nick Patrick, and that was very, very, very close.
And you know, Nick Patrick says he's going to call it right down the middle. He's not going to show any favoritism. He's not going to show, he's not going to be brought into the offices and be belittled and yelled at anymore. He's just going to call it straight. If you like him, you like him. If you don't, you don't. That's what he's doing.
Jerry Lynn climbing. He is up on top. Oh, to the midsection, Juventud. He tried it one too many times.
You can't go to the well too many times with Hoovy.
Juventud, that is. Pushed him off to Jerry Lynn.
Oh!
He tried another thrust kick, but that time swept away by Guerrera.
I'd have gone for the pin there.
Juventud Guerrera.
Where's he going now?
His hero can punch you. Up on top. One.
Same to you, Shivani.
Three. And that's his premier move.
What?
The hero can punch
you. Oh, I thought you were cursing at me.
No. Oh, I have, but not here on television. The winner is
Cheetah Marina.
The Juventud Guerrera is your winner. The fans were behind Jerry Lynn here, and Guerrera, a little bit of an attitude, much the same that Conan has brought to the United States as well. And Brain, you can take this one on away if you like.
Well, my pleasure. Hoovy comes off the top rope here in a somersault. Nails his opponent with a drop kick, nips up. Now look at this. Lands on the top rope like the Flying Melendez. Gets him in a sort of a Mexican Frankensteiner, if there is such a thing. Hooks the legs for the 1-2-3. And there's your winner, Juventud. But you know as well as I do, we can all call him Hoovy. Because he's our pal. He's from south of the border. La, 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 la.
In addition to the man we just saw, Juventud Guerrera, we will see Super Calo from Mexico making his worldwide debut a little bit later on. Plus, our main event, Chris Benoit and Arn Anderson against the Rock and Roll Express. But you're not going to find a main event any bigger than coming up at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc on Sunday, October 27th from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas. The Macho Man and Hulk Hogan for the WCW World Heavyweight title.
Well, you know, when Savage lost his wife, that pushed him to the edge. When Savage lost all his money, that pushed him a little closer to the edge. And that's the way this man likes to live. Well, now going through what this man has gone through, now realizing that the weight of the WCW is on the shoulders of the Macho Man, he likes this edge, and the edge is going to be you, Hulk Hogan, because he's going to go right through that edge and bring the championship right here to WCW. That's the kind of a man Savage is.
Let's remind you, it is the WCW belt, not the NWO. Back with more Worldwide after this timeout.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by Double Mint Gum. Put that one-of-a-kind taste in your face and feel good. Double Mint Gum, it's the fun part. Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Dentine Gum. In less than 60 seconds, Dentine's tingly taste will make your breath feel fresh and clean. Brush your breath with Dentine.
At Rent-A-Center, you can try it before you buy it, so you never get stuck with anything you don't want. We guarantee it. Call 1-800-546-4900 now to find out how.
Hot Pockets, filled with pepperoni pizza or ham and cheese in a crispy crust.
What are you gonna pick?
Hot Pockets.
Try Lean Pockets, too.
The Slim Jim Halloween Havoc event is coming your way on Sunday, October 27th. It will start at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. That's right now. Usually, it's 7 o'clock Eastern Time for a Sunday pay-per-view spectacular. This time, it's 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Available only on pay-per-view, Brain.
There is the man.
That's the man?
That's the man.
What do you mean, the man?
That's the man who has the ring that everyone's looking for.
Yeah, but he's
that's not the man that everyone's jealous of. He told me that.
He doesn't own the ring anymore. Are we going to have a running argument here?
He thinks he does.
He lost it to Eddie Guerrero back in the month of August. Clash of the Champions, Denver, Colorado. Do you remember?
Well, yes, but he told me he wouldn't lie to me, would he?
Yeah, I think we wouldn't. No, he'd just take millions of dollars away from the booty babe. No, he wouldn't lie to you.
Of course he wouldn't lie to me.
And here he comes. His opponent, your favorite Brain, the Disco Inferno.
Tony, you're going to get dirty. Quit break dancing. This is disco music. I've got a new outfit.
The Disco Inferno making his way to the ring. Want to let our fans know in the Las Vegas area that tickets are still available at the MGM Grand Garden box office and all Ticketmaster locations for Halloween Havoc, the event at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas. It's Slim Jim Halloween Havoc coming your way on Sunday, the 27th of October at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage, and already look at what has happened to the Disco Inferno here.
Well, he's not dancing too much right now, but he's got to stay focused, especially when you're in the ring with a man like Diamond Dallas.
Oh, Diamond Dallas is ruthless.
And I got a phone call the other day from Mike Tyson.
You did?
Yeah, Mike said, are you going to be in Vegas for Halloween Havoc? I said, I certainly am. He said, I'm coming to the fight. I said, why, Mike? He said, I haven't seen a good fight for such a long time.
I guess he hasn't. Not in that arena, he hasn't. Slim Jim presents Halloween Havoc exclusively on pay-per-view. What an event this should be, fans.
And what a tremendous facility that is over there at the MGM.
Oh, yes, it is. It is truly the biggest hotel I've ever seen in my life. Hotel, casino. One, two, they have a amusement park for children, a big arena.
And everybody gets a newspaper in the morning. I had two the other day.
Two newspapers?
Well, I had to go across the hall and get the other one, but I got two.
Why would you get someone else's newspaper out?
Well, no one was out there. I didn't know whose it was. It was just laying in the hall by the door. There was a lot of them laying in the hall by the door.
That's right.
I had 35 newspapers what I really had.
Did you sell those newspapers?
They go for a half a buck.
Yeah, I bet they do.
26 cents in the lobby. Here you can unload the whole one minute.
Here you go. To the midsection goes Diamond Dallas. Just go in front of. Spins him around. Oh! Diamond Dallas. Nails.
Boy, he's hearing some tunes right now. He didn't push the button to hear. Oh, yeah. He has really put his finger on the trigger of the hottest 45s in town right there. Yeah, Disco's got to get a trainer. He's got to get a trainer, a mental trainer, that can keep him focused. He's got to turn off the records. He's got to forget, quit watching Laverne and Shirley, and he's got to start thinking more about his career in that ring.
Back body drop. Oh, look at this little Disco dancing. It cost him one, two. That time, Disco Inferno almost got a win because his opponent was doing some disco dancing. How about that turn of events? One, two, and Randy Eller says no, only two.
You know, Diamond wastes a little time, too, here. I mean, Disco's just a half a step away from being a major star here at WCW, which he is a major singing and dancing star all over the world.
Right.
But, I mean, he just needs a couple of those victories just to push him over the top, and this could do it. You just can't waste time.
Every music store I go in and every town across the world that we travel, I have never seen one disco CD.
Sold out. Isn't it amazing? What business he's doing.
I've never seen any orders placed for it.
You don't see much of that album either, Waylon Willie and Sinatra. That's always sold out too, must be.
Waylon Willie and Sinatra. And elbow, that is right in the midsection. A little warning there from Nick Patrick. Very close to being a low blow, but Diamond Dallas making sure that we all know that was on target and right now taunting the Disco Inferno.
Of course, you won't see many Burl-eyed Snoopy Dogg albums either doing rap.
No.
But he sells a lot of albums.
You say Snoopy Dogg?
Snoopy Dogg.
Yeah, the rapper.
Forget, stop, please stop. Let's get out of the music mode here and back into the ring, into the midst. Stupid dog.
You like him too, huh?
Yeah, boy, I love him. Left hand.
I like that album he did with Waylon Jennings.
Yes. I like the one he did with Charlie Brown too. An elbow on the top of the head.
You idiot. That's James Brown. You imbecile.
Into the rope. A back elbow.
Well, Disco's taking over here now.
Boy, thank goodness he has, because we've lost it. Driving down with the knee into Diamond Dallas. A big comeback mounted by Disco Inferno.
There we go.
Swinging neck breaker.
I guess you noticed that Gladys Knight oils
One,
her band.
Two.
Did you know that?
Oils her band?
Yeah, she doesn't like her pips to squeak.
I knew we'd sink to a new low. Diamond cutter! Oh! And the moral is...
The music is stopped.
Yeah, the moral is, don't do any disco dancing when the diamond cutter's behind you.
Exactly, Mr. Schiavone. That's a lesson to be learned by the Disco Inferno here. This man, Diamond Dallas, is too arrogant, too cocky, and too tough.
Really smushing up the hair.
You know why he can do that? Because he can.
Yeah, because his opponent's out.
That's the best way.
Yeah, you're not kidding.
Didn't you ever slap a guy when he was out cold?
No, never have. Never slapped a guy, as a matter of fact.
You're kidding.
No, never have.
Come on, I'll show you. I'll introduce you to Oakland later on. You can slap him all you want.
Really?
Sure.
Well, I might take you up. No, what am I saying? Your winner is the Disco Inferno. Dwight Gooden here is with us this week here on Worldwide Wrestling.
Never looked better. There you see Disco Inferno. Spins the big man around. But does he ever get clotheslined? He's hearing tunes that haven't even been recorded yet. You can't dance when you're in the ring with this man, because you're going to get your diamond cut real quick. Courtesy of Diamond Dallas Page. And now back to Tony Schiavone and all his little Snoopy-Doo friends.
Thank you, Bobby the Brain. And we take you now to the man that Brain wants to slap, Gene Okerlund.
Gene Okerlund here at the Control Center as we head for our next pay-per-view spectacular. Slim Jim presents Halloween Havoc on Sunday, October the 27th at a very special starting time of 8 p.m. Eastern. Live out of the West Coast. Call your cable operator right now for availability. Satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier or DirecTV. This event is going to be originating from the MGM Grand in Action City, Las Vegas, Nevada. What a setting it's going to be for the most anticipated world title bout that I've seen in many, many years. Heavyweight champ Hulk Hogan to defend against the Macho Man Randy Savage. I don't have to tell you the importance of this match. Hogan won the title back in August at Hog Wild in Sturgis, South Dakota. Since that time, he's defaced the title and has claimed it to be the NWO Championship, not WCW. Hogan and the NWO have made a shambles of WCW over the past few months, and seemingly everyone has felt the wrath, including the Macho Man himself. Take a look. Macho Man is going to be looking for paybacks. This is going to be a great one, fans, so make your plans now to join us exclusively on pay-per-view. Satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier at 1-800-843-9266. DirecTV, 1-800-347-3288. And we're going to be back next week with more about Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. Live from Las Vegas, Sunday, October the 27th at 8.
WCW Worldwide Wrestling continues with a debut here. We saw earlier Juventud Guerrero, one of the top cruiserweight contenders in the world from Mexico. Here's another from Mexico. Our first look on Worldwide Wrestling at Super Calo.
I've heard a lot about this man. I want to get a look at him, a close look.
Very unique attire, wouldn't you say, Brain?
Well, you don't work at an airport.
Well, at least he doesn't work at an airport in the United States. Super Calo makes his entrance, and he has to contend with a man who went all the way, Brain, to the championship of the Cruiserweight Tournament recently, Brad Armstrong.
Well, you can't take a back seat to Brad Armstrong. The man's a top competitor, has been for years. Very tragic accident happened to him about a week ago.
What, Brown? I didn't hear about that. I would have known.
Well, he lives in Marietta, Georgia.
Yes.
And he stopped at a convenience store, I guess, a couple of days ago, and three rednecks jumped out of a truck and saw him in his wrestling jacket and run him up on a flagpole for 9 days.
Where did you get that information?
Marietta Monthly.
And Gazette. Marietta Monthly and Gazette?
Top reading.
You have spent way too much time in a hotel room. The matchup, Super Callow and Brad Armstrong here on WCW Worldwide. Randy Anderson, the referee.
Smartest masked man in the world, they say.
What, Super Callow? Why do they say that?
Because he can hear what they're saying about him.
Apparently so. The ears are obviously sticking out of the mask there. That is very unique.
You better. He's taking a left.
His whole attire is unique. The hat, the shades, the mask. Super Callow.
It's getting on to 1997. You're going to see a lot of strange things in this world.
Well, you sure are.
Especially here at WCW.
Brett Armstrong is as fundamentally sound a wrestler as you'll find in the sport. And he has to combat this unique style that Super Callow brings to the ring, much like Guerrero, Juventud Guerrero, like Conan, like Rey Mysterio Jr. Snapmare takeover.
Oh!
How about that move? Jumping on the back of the head. Sitting on the back of the head.
Now, are those glasses that are made into the mask? Those can't be regular glasses he's wearing.
They would have to be glasses made into the mask, yes.
He wouldn't be that stupid to wear glasses in the ring. Look at this. Look at that.
I don't think WCW would allow that either. It's a cross body block and a shoulder block takedown. And Super Callow ducking through, showing some power. How about this? An arm drag taking Brad Armstrong all the way out.
Cross body to an arm drag.
How about that? Brad Armstrong very crossed up here.
It seems like he's getting a little cross.
Oh, a double drop kick, if you will. Over the Super Callow with a high-risk maneuver, springboarding from inside out and doing basically like a somersault, landing on the back of or the front of Brett Armstrong.
And Armstrong had no place to go. His back was flat, flush on that floor, and he took the compression of that blow.
Super Callow.
Oh, I know his girlfriend.
Super Callow's girlfriend?
Mary.
Mary. I don't think I know her.
Mary Poppins.
I get Super Callow, fragilistic, expert. Yeah, good.
No, no, his last name's Gonzalez.
Would you stop? Up on
top! Oh!
He tried a reverse splash that time.
His hat's still on. That amazes me.
How about that? Armstrong sent Super Callow in, back body drop.
Must be John Wayne's kid.
And Brad Armstrong, big clothesline. Brad Armstrong.
His hat's still on.
Has the Russian leg sweep. One, two, three. Brad Armstrong beats it.
Oh, he did. Very, very impressive, too.
I tell you, the cruiserweight division, you cannot overlook Brad Armstrong.
He's a sleeper.
That's right, with the Russian leg sweep, much like the diamond cutter, when that is put on, the match is over.
Well, you're right about that. The match is really, really over when he slaps that on. You know, Callow had a good chance here, but Armstrong understood what this man was doing. He was going to do a lot of aerial moves, and Armstrong was just going to get out of his way. Armstrong had done his homework. What I like is his hat has never come off yet. Armstrong gets him in the Russian leg sweep, floats over on top of him for the 1-2-3. It won't be hats off for Super Callow. It's back to Mary Poppins. You're going home all by yourself, pal.
When we come back, a big eight-man tag team event, including the Dungeon of Doom.
Eight-man.
That's what I said.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Gotta have beef. Gotta have spice. Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim. Oh, yeah.
Dentine gum. In less than 60 seconds, Dentine's tingly taste will make your breath feel fresh and clean. Brush your breath with Dentine.
When you build a country by hand, you're going to get a little dirty doing it. And for 100 years, Pumice Powered Lava has been cleaning the hands that make America strong.
We welcome you back once again, fans, to the number one wrestling syndicated program around the world. It's WCW Worldwide Wrestling. We come to you each and every week from the Disney MGM Studios in Orlando. Brian, I want to get your opinion. We've been talking a lot about the great action we've been seeing, and we've talked a lot about Hulk Hogan, the Macho Man Randy Savage. The main event is Slim Jim Halloween Havoc. And I tell you, Hulk Hogan has spray-painted the belt. He's got the NWO logo spray-painted in black across the big gold front of the belt. He claims it's the NWO belt, but it's still the centerpiece of what this sport has been, because you're talking about all the way back in 1905, that world title belt became a reality. And now in 1996, some 91 years later, he's going to all of a sudden change it to the NWO belt. That's not going to happen.
You know, I managed some of the greatest wrestlers in this sport against people that owned that belt at one time. I'm talking about no man I ever managed were lucky enough to accomplish winning that title, because I had a bunch of ham and eggers at different times.
Maybe
wasn't my fault.
Maybe they were mismanaged.
Never mind.
No, wait a minute. Braun has made his appearance once again.
You realize his gums are as green as his jacket?
Yes, I do. And once again, he's chasing our technicians around the ring. He's grabbing the legs of opponents here. We've seen him bite referees.
I mean, some of the greatest wrestlers in our sport. I mean, Buddy Rogers. I even wrestled that man, Buddy Rogers. I managed against Gene Kaninsky. I managed against Jack Briscoe, Funks. I mean, you name it. Pat O'Connor, Ric Flair, Randy Macho Man Savage, and now Hulk Hogan is going to disgrace that?
Not a chance. This eight-man tag has erupted into a brawl here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling.
More like a battle royal. Hugh Morris is going to... You mind if I say that?
No, go ahead.
You gave me a dirty look. I shouldn't say Hugh Morris.
No, you can say Hugh Morris if you want.
Hugh Morris. I'm not talking anymore.
A pickup and a scoop slam.
I don't want to talk. You've insulted me.
I'm not insulting you. I'm taking a look at the Dungeon of Doom. Here are men who are much like everyone else at WCW, right behind a man who's been their arch enemy for many, many years, the Macho Man Randy Savage.
And you know the man Ming's in the ring with there, don't you?
Yes.
You know who that man is?
Yep, Tony Mella.
That's right. Let's make sure you got all your stuff right here. So you know who the man in the striped outfit is, don't you?
Which striped outfit? Yeah, Pepe Prado.
You know his brother Don?
Don? Big Bubba goes through the bottom rope and an uppercut. And Big Bubba sending Tony Mella crashing.
Right on top of his melon.
Yes, Mella. It's M-E-L-L-A.
Doesn't matter.
And here's Big Max rolling Tony Mella in.
With two X's. Big Max. Yeah, Savage really has his work cut out for him. I mean, what that man's gone through, you know, his body is not 100%. And we all know his mind isn't all there. And maybe that's what he's going to have to get by everybody at the NWO. But I'll tell you something. There's a lot of people here at WCW. I'm going to say everyone here is going to make sure that that title comes back to where it belongs.
I think you're right. Picking up Prado here is the Barbarian. The Barbarian is just so overpowering in this sport. Everyone he faces, he just seems to overwhelm with his power. And here comes Big Bubba. So far, Hugh Morris, faces of fear, and Big Bubba dominating this eight-man tag. Max, Jimmy Hart on the outside, the Bubba slam.
You know, Big Bubba's got a personal thing going with Glacier.
Yes,
he doesn't
does.
Like the guy at all. Calls him Mr. This and that. I mean, I can't even tell you some of the things I've heard him say about him.
Well, as we said, we're going to be seeing Glacier in the weeks to come. We understand here on Worldwide. We look forward to seeing that. And now, up on top, the Barbarian with Prado has him hooked. Look at this.
Prado's going to land pronto.
Oh, over the top end of the mat. Here's the lateral press from the Barbarian. And the faces of fear, Big Bubba, Hugh Morris, members of Dungeon Doom get a win, and they're not finished yet. Hugh Morris is going to execute his moonsault from the top. Look at this.
Oh, so much for Pepe Prado.
That's Pepe Prado.
Now it's Pepe Prado.
Oh, my. Sorry,
check fans. Where he's been laying.
The Dungeon of Doom continues to be a force in this sport, and they're looking forward to Slim Jim Halloween Havoc as well. Right now, we send you to Mean Gene.
See you, Pepe.
Gene O'Connor here at the Control Center as we head for our next pay-per-view spectacular. Slim Jim presents Halloween Havoc on Sunday, October the 27th, at a very special starting time of 8 p.m. Eastern. 5 out of the West Coast. Call your cable operator right now for availability. Satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier or DirecTV. This event is going to be originating from the MGM Grand in Action City, Las Vegas, Nevada. What a setting it's going to be for the most anticipated world title bout that I've seen in many, many years. Heavyweight champ Hulk Hogan to defend against the Macho Man Randy Savage. I don't have to tell you the importance of this match. Hogan won the title back in August at Hog Wild in Sturgis, South Dakota. Since that time, he's defaced the title and has claimed it to be the NWO Championship, not WCW. Hogan and the NWO have made a shambles of WCW over the past few months, and seemingly everyone has felt the wrath, including the Macho Man himself. Take a look. Macho Man is going to be looking for paybacks. This is going to be a great one, fans, so make your plans now to join us exclusively on pay-per-view. Satellite dish owners, call Turner Premier at 1-800-843-9266. DirecTV, 1-800-347-3288. And we're going to be back next week with more about Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, live from Las Vegas, Sunday, October the 27th at 8.
We continue with the superstars of World Championship Wrestling. It's time for our main event tag team here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling as we count down the weeks now to Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, Sunday, the 27th of October, 8 o'clock Eastern Time, and only on pay-per-view.
You think Vegas has been alive before? Uh-uh. Nothing like this.
Nothing on the strip has been like it before, and nothing since then at the MGM Grand. WCW Worldwide Wrestling comes to you, of course, from Disney's MGM Studio. Here they are, former World Tag Team Champions of the Rock and Roll Express, Brain.
Not just one time, not two times. Five times.
The World Tag Team Champs, but they must collide with two men who mean business now more than ever, the Horsemen.
Now, if you had to pick a winner in this match, most people would pick Rock and Roll Express because they've been together longer and they know each other better. But the Horsemen have momentum. And I don't care how many tag teams there are in this world, this one man right there, Arn Anderson, can take any tag team apart single-handedly. I bet him on any day. I bet if I was in trouble or needed somebody to watch my back, he'd be the man I pick. And this man single-handedly can do it all.
Back with the main event after this timeout.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT, the way to save on collect calls.
Back on Worldwide, time for the main event, and I tell you, Brain, there's so much excitement and so much momentum gathering towards Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc on Sunday, October 27th. We are over a month away now, but still the excitement is out there. And you were in Las Vegas, you, the Macho Man Randy Savage, and Gene Okerlund were a big autograph signing back in August when tickets first went on sale. And what a crowd we had there, I understand, at the Grand Garden Box Office.
That's right. We were there for about an hour and a half signing autographs, talking to the fans. I didn't really have much to do with a whole lot of them. But there were lines outside the door, down the street, around the corner. I never saw that many people standing in line to see me.
Ricky Morton rolls up Arn Anderson. It's a one. One count only that time.
But they love me in Vegas. Every time I come here, some hotel's got a sign up saying, Old Blue Eyes is back. Isn't that nice?
That's probably for Frank Sinatra.
Who?
Never mind.
Was he the guy that was on a motorcycle and tried to jump those fountains?
No. That's Evel Knievel. That was Evel Knievel who tried to jump. Why am I explaining this to you?
I don't know.
Why do I waste my time with this? Let's get back to the match. A back chop and a rake to the eyes. Chris Benoit showing why he is one of the toughest and most intense competitors in our sport. A pickup of Ricky Morton. And Ricky Morton comes out with a flying head scissor maneuver.
And you know what I like about Benoit? He's always wanted to be a horseman. A kid that always wanted to be a baseball player is going to be a good player. A kid that has lived football all his life or basketball or anything like that. This man has wanted to be a wrestler and a horseman, and now his dreams come true. So how are you going to beat a guy like this with that kind of determination?
That's right. He's making the most of it. Robert Gibson gets the exchange in. Robert Gibson caught by Benoit. Robert Gibson kicks him in the back of the head.
I mean, just like you, Tony, you always wanted a home-cooked meal.
Still never had one. Into the midsection again. To the side of the head. Randy Eller checking in to Robert Gibson. Chris Benoit, he's best when you're caught in the corner. Gibson beels him out of the corner, and Robert Gibson up on top with a head scissor takeover. Oh, and he wanted an arm drag, and Benoit caught him, and Benoit's going to send him into the corner. This is where you don't want to be against the Horsemen.
Now, this is a very bad neighborhood. But I'll tell you something about the Rock and Roll Express, how good they are, how really, really good they are. You're not going to see a lot of flash out of them like you do Rey Mysterio or Eddie Guerrero or people like that. But they are sound tag teams. They complement each other. One always knows where the other one is. One's always protecting the other one. The same with Arn and Flair and the partners Arn's had. I mean, this is a fundamentally sound, great tag team. And to beat them is very impressive.
Oh! Arn Anderson missed, and that cost him that time because Robert Gibson, that is, the type of athlete that will take advantage of it and rolls Arn Anderson back in. Twice now, the arm to the ring post. And Robert Gibson on the attack here for the Rock and Roll Express. Be such a big win for Ricky and Robert here.
Do you know Robert and Ricky Morton, Rock and Roll Express, are card-carrying members still of the Monkees fan club?
I don't believe that at all.
I saw him walk into a place one day and the people started yelling, hey, hey, there's the Flunkies.
A leg trip down, holding the arm, and driving the knee in. Great teamwork. That's been one of the trademarks of Ricky and Robert.
Hey, you know
the Flunkies.
Oh, you heard the same song?
You never stop, do you? I mean, you always take an opportunity to run down someone.
I don't drive.
Pulling on the arm, I give up with you. Into the corner. Arn Anderson hits the arm once again. That's three times now on that arm. And Ricky Morton, fist of fire on top of the head. And oof. Oh, my goodness, what a counter move that was by Double A. Chris Benoit. Benoit loves this, man. You talking about a man that can stomp you when you're down.
The Crippler.
Chris Benoit, Ricky Morton, virtually helpless at the bottom of the ropes there. And the Wolverine, as they call him within the ranks of the Horsemen, living up to his name.
He's young and he's hungry and he's got talent. He's got more talent, I hate to say it, in his little finger than most wrestlers have had in their whole career.
Well,
this man is
that.
Unstoppable.
Yeah, I agree with that. He fears no man. We've said it before, Chris Benoit.
That's a shame about Ricky Morton being arrested.
Wait, do I have to go into this? What do you mean Ricky Morton was arrested?
Yeah, they got him for impersonating a Barbie doll.
But there you see Robert Gibson extending the arm. He wants the tag.
He was arrested for being Ken. Horrible scandal. I don't want to go into it.
In the corner now, Ricky Morton sent through the ropes into the floor. At the feet of Arn Anderson, that's a dangerous place to be. There you see Benoit has the attention of the referee, and now it's Ricky Morton's turn to face the steal.
Get back in here, Barbie. They're so tough.
One,
so tough.
Two, but they may be tough, and yes, they are, but in the same breath, you got to say the Rock and Roll Express will never give up. They're as tough as they come as well.
Well, Barbie will give up when both those arms are pulled off.
It's Ricky Morton.
Ricky, sorry. I wonder if you could switch the heads on.
Look at the head stomping away.
It'd be fun to try, though, wouldn't
it? You've lost it. You know that?
Haven't lost it. Look at Arn Anderson here. Talking to the referee. Drawing in Robert Morton. Great tag team wrestling.
It's Robert Gibson.
Robert Gibson or Ricky Morton or who cares who they are? They're
we
Rock
do.
And, Roll Express.
And the wrestling fans care.
Well, their name sounds alike. They're close enough. They're cousins, you know.
Shoulder block over the top. If you don't know their names, how do you know their cousins? A left hand at the top of the head, Arn Anderson, and Ricky Morton still holds on. And there's Benoit holding on, and there's Robert Gibson in. One, two, got him down for a sunset flip for two.
See, that's the Rock and Roll Express's time work. That's how they work together. They got the greatest timing of any team, a lot of wrestlers have always said. They're very hard to beat. They stay in their corner. They're in and out. Nobody stays in there too long. But Arn Anderson is just such a tough individual.
One of the greatest there is Ricky Morton extending the hand to Robert Gibson. Can he make the tag? That's right. Ricky Morton on the inside. Robert Gibson on the outside.
See, it's easier if you just use Barbie and Ken.
Would you probably mix that up. Was the tag made or not? It was not made. If it was, the referee didn't see it. We could not see it from our vantage point. Meanwhile, a double team on Ricky Morton.
And the referee has to see it. If you don't believe me, ask Nick Patrick. Don't waste time with him, though. I'll tell you about the Rock and Roll Express. A lot of times they were playing possum. You think you got him hurt, all of a sudden,
They're so tricky. They're so swift and fast, they can just get behind you and take it one, two, three, before you even know it.
Chris Benoit, Ricky Morton's mounting a little comeback here. He's had about enough, and we've got toe-to-toe fisticuffs going on here. Ricky Morton gets the better of Benoit. How about that?
But he knows he's got to get to that corner.
Oh!
He's got to get to a fresh can.
That is a fresh Robert Gibson. And a stomp from Benoit, and here's Arn Anderson. It's been a great tag team match.
Well, I would say the horsemen are ahead on points, though.
Well, there's no point.
Why isn't there a point system? And I could be the judge of it.
Well, that's why.
Oh!
How about that? How many points would you give him for that?
Which one?
Oh, forget it.
Arn to get 50 points for coming off the rope. Morton to get none for laying on his back. Arn to get 50 points for headbutting
the foot of Ricky
Morton.
Morton. Tag. Robert Gibson's in. Chris Benoit's in.
Well, we got a fresh can in there now.
It's Robert Gibson and back elbow to the gut of Arn Anderson, sending Benoit to the ropes with the back elbow. Ricky Morton sends him outside. Scoop slam Gibson.
See, they always know where each other are. That's good teamwork. Double drop kick.
Double drop kick.
They've done this before.
But they're moving Ricky Morton out.
Too much time.
That enables the Wolverine to get up top. Here he goes. Oh, a big double accent on the back of the head. Arn Anderson flops right over.
One, two, three.
Thank you for counting with me.
Don't mention it.
The Horsemen win yet another match over the Rock and Roll Express. A big win here on Worldwide Wrestling.
Well, it's always a big win when you can knock off the Rock and Roll Express. Or as I affectionately like to refer to them, Ken and Barbie. You pick who you like as Barbie or Ken. I have mine.
Sunday, October 27th, it's the Slim Jim Halloween Havoc, the Macho Man, and Hulk Hogan for the WCW World Title Brain. Unprecedented move. You know the Horsemen, including Ric Flair, behind the efforts of the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
You know, everyone is behind the efforts of Randy Macho Man Savage. You know, right here in this town of Las Vegas, the last big fight you saw here lasted 109 seconds. Hogan, if you think you're going to slip out of town that easy, Savage has big plans for you. He has to drag your carcass into the desert and rip that WCW belt off your body. He's going to do it. You people want a big fight? This is the place for it. Hogan, get ready for the fight of your life, pal.
We're Bobby the Brain Heenan. I'm Tony Schiavone. See you in 1 week on WCW Worldwide Wrestling.
And this week, Super Calo one-on-one against Rey Mysterio Jr.
And we also have from Germany, Alex Wright. And you will like him.
Yeah, you sure will. Plus, you'll see Stevie Ray of Harlem Heat against one half of the Steiner brothers, Rick Steiner.
And the rich man from Wall Street, BK Wall Street.
Plus, the Dungeon of Doom and the main event all coming up next. This is Tony Schiavone and Bobby the Brain Heenan. Welcome to WCW Worldwide. As always, this is the Worldwide Arena from the Disney MGM Studio in Orlando. And I tell you, Brain, we start out with a dandy. Super Calo Rey Mysterio Jr. We've seen him before for the first time ever here on Worldwide.
WCW Worldwide, we are number one, Schiavone. People have been standing in line here for hours to get in.
Yes, they have, and you've been very rude to people all day today, I must say.
What, they want to charge for an autograph?
Yeah, I mean, Mickey and Goofy don't even charge for autographs, for crying out loud. And you want to charge $5 a letter.
Not $5 a letter.
Oh, well, that's not what it was?
No.
All right. Rey Mysterio Jr., WCW's Cruiserweight Champion, making his way to the ring here on Worldwide.
It was $159.50 with the videotape and t-shirt.
Next thing you know, we've seen NWO merchandise commercials. Gonna have some Bobby the Brain Heenan merchandise commercials pretty soon. Super Calo, a man who has made quite a name for himself in the span of 2 weeks. Ever since he made his debut on Fall Brawl, Brain, he's been very, very impressive. He went up against Rey Mysterio Jr. They had a tremendous match. Did not get the Cruiserweight Championship, but Rey Mysterio Jr. is a young man who's hard to keep down.
Very hard to keep down. You know, and everybody's talking about Eddie Guerrero. Everybody's talking about Dean Malenko. Everybody's talking about the Cruiserweight division, the Brad Armstrong.
But right now, this is the hottest talent going right now here at WCW in the Cruiserweight division, and that's Rey Mysterio Jr. right there, and he is the champion. And I thought this kettle was just some goof with sunglasses and a leather hat, but I watched, this man has ability. That's just what he likes to wear in the ring. That's his style.
Rey Mysterio Jr. hooks the body scissors on. Callow has him, but he comes out with an arm drag. Nicely done, but a shoulder block takedown. Ladies and gentlemen, at Halloween Havoc, brought to you by Slim Jim, we do understand Rey Mysterio Jr. will be defending his Cruiserweight Championship against former champion Dean Malenko. That match signed, of course, Hulk Hogan, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, for the Heavyweight Championship of the World. Look at that Frankensteiner-type move from a springboard.
Watch
on the
this.
Top.
Watch
Here
this.
He goes!
Oh!
He lands on Super Callow and hurt his knee in the process, I believe.
Well, he took a lot of that fall right on his back there. Callow didn't get it that much. I think going backwards down the steps did more damage to him than Mysterio did catching him. He'd have caught him flush. The match would be over right now. This is a chiropractor's dream, a match like this.
Yes. Up on top, oh! Super Callow with a drop kick. Great anticipation from Super Callow that time. And this 21-year-old champion is in trouble here. Rey Mysterio Jr. sends him into the ropes, up and down, oh. Powerbomb. Callow just puts him back on his feet to clothesline him outside. He lands on his feet again, but he's hurting here. Callow!
Oh! Kamikaze if I've ever seen it.
My goodness. Called a suicide-type dive, and that's exactly what it is.
You know, I'd like to have this match on a rooftop to see what would happen.
Yeah, well, you would see one of those moves on the outside. That would be it. Up on top. In the ropes. Pick up. Side salto spinning nicely. Super Callow very confident right now, feeling that he is moments away from being the next Cruiserweight champion of the world.
Do not try this at home.
Please don't. Rey Mysterio, great leg strength. Throws him up, one, two, three.
He got him. He got him.
The moral is you can't waste a second when you're competing against Rey Mysterio Jr. A little bit of showboating. Didn't take but about 10 seconds or so. Still talking to Dean Malenko. He's going to get Dean Malenko at Halloween Havoc. But if you waste a few seconds like Super Callow did, you're going to lose to Rey Mysterio Jr. He's your winner in the opening bout here on WCW Worldwide Wrestling. You look at our tremendous crowd again, Brain.
Well, he's wrestling Dean Malenko, and Dean Malenko's been training. He's been in the Orient, and he's not the champion. This man right here, look at the amount of abuse this man's taking. And Rey Mysterio Jr. is the Cruiserweight champion. That means he's been wrestling the best. He's been traveling. The man has a very tough schedule. I look for the advantage to go to Dean Malenko. Yes, you can do all these moves, all these great, great Cruiserweight moves, but so can Dean Malenko. He's the man of a thousand holes. Super Callow, a tremendous opponent for Rey Mysterio Jr. I think he was a little too bit overconfident. Rey Mysterio waited for the opportune moment and took advantage of it. That's why he's champion. But Dean Malenko, a former Cruiserweight champion and a very good champion, could become champion again. The 1-2-3, your winner, Rey Mysterio Jr. And for the other man, Super Callow, frozen tacos.
Don't forget, fans, still to come in this telecast, Rick Steiner one-on-one against Stevie Ray of Harlem Heat. Also in tag team action, we will see the Armstrong brothers against the Taskmaster and Conan of the Dungeon of Doom. But Brain, as we head now to Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc on Sunday, October 27th, the last scene we had of Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage was taken back at Fall Brawl. At the end of that very disgusting scene, Miss Elizabeth tries to intervene to help out the Macho Man Randy Savage. They end up
do that.
I never thought I'd see Hogan do that. I think it's very obvious that she needs to stay away from the ring. It's very dangerous when the NWO's in there.
Very dangerous for us to be around the ring in NWOs or even be around the building. But it's going to be more dangerous for Hulk Hogan when he puts his title on the line against Savage. It's going to be very dangerous.
I should say our title on the line, yeah, against the Macho Man Randy Savage. Back with more Worldwide Wrestling after this timeout from the Disney MGM studio.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT, the way to save on collect calls. Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Dentine gum. In less than 60 seconds, Dentine's tingly taste will make your breath feel fresh and clean. Brush your breath with Dentine.
at Rent-A-Center, you can try it before you buy it, so you never get stuck with anything you don't want. We guarantee it. Call 1-800-546-4900 now to find out how.
Hot pockets filled with pepperoni pizza or ham and cheese in a crispy crust.
What are you gonna pick?
Hot pockets. Try lean pockets, too.
Oh, WCW Worldwide, Disney, MGM Studios, Tony and the Brain. Good to have you with us. Halloween Havoc is coming up, Brain. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, Hulk Hogan, WCW World Title in Las Vegas at the MGM Grand.
And there he is from Germany, Alex Wright. You think he'd have a German name like Von Wright?
They love him, there's no doubt about it. Alex Wright making his way to the ring for this match here. Hey, he's very agile. Okay, he's very agile. Hello, are you there with me?
Okay, he's very agile. What do you want me to do? Stand back while I do a backflip, because he's agile.
Want to remind our fans, coming to the event in Las Vegas, the tickets are available at the MGM Grand box office, Grand Garden box office, and all Ticketmaster locations. It's going to be a tremendous event. Slim Jim's presents Halloween Havoc on Sunday, the 27th of October, the event exclusively on pay-per-view. Also, fans, call your local cable operator for availability, DirecTV, or Turner Premier for the mini dish or satellite dish, and be a part of all the action.
I'd like to remind the fans of one more important thing.
What's that?
He's agile.
Thank you.
Don't mention it.
Nick Patrick, the referee. Randy Starr complained about Alex Wright. Was he pulling the hair?
Nick, you think he's going to say yes if he did?
Hey, how about the Macho Man knocking Nick Patrick on his rear end not too long ago?
Well, see, that shows you how deranged that man is. If he is that nuts, or if he's just trying to make us think he's that nuts. But for you to want to have people think you're that nuts, you must be nuts. Now, do they fine him? They suspend him? No, they let him get away with it. But that's fine. They let the NWO get away with anything. Let Savage push some people around. I don't care anymore.
And that's just a little evidence there of what the NWO has done to us. I never before in the history of my broadcast career ever wanted to see a wrestler hit a referee. Never liked it. But when he nailed Nick Patrick, I kind of liked it. And they've done that to us. They've caused the feeling within our company.
Tony,
they've made us what we are.
They're brainwashing us is what they're doing. They're feeding us little bits of information that they want us to have. Not that we're finding out on our own. And then what they're doing, then they're picking us apart. They're offering this money, this much money. They're making demands. They want this, they want that. And what's happening? We're backing into a corner and giving it to them. What we should do is just stand in the middle and pick up some chainsaws and go after them.
Chainsaws, good plan.
They do it to us.
You're not kidding.
This is war.
They, you know, and it, to be very honest with you, it wasn't too long ago on one of our television programs, our cameras caught them destroying Lex Luger's car. Now, you're not telling me that Lex Luger's not going to go to the police? It's on videotape. It's evidence. Put him in the slammer. Put him in jail. Oh, I'm sorry. The New World Order can't show up. They're in the slammer. That would stop it right now.
No, it wouldn't, because Hogan and DiBiase would get four or five or six or seven more goons, and they'd do the same thing as somebody else. For the next time, they'd make sure there were no cameras. They'd beat up the cameraman. I'm telling you, you got to be careful of these guys. They mean business. There's millions and millions, maybe billions of dollars at stake here.
Yeah, well, you're right about meaning business. There's no doubt they are very serious about what they're doing, and they've been very effective. They have added new men to the list. We have seen man number six now.
And Hogan said it was going to be 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Quite a grip.
Oh.
How about this? Randy Starr not impressed at all with young Alex Wright.
And you notice they're all getting along. They're all riding in Wimos together. They're sipping on the bubbly. They're watching TV. They're dropping out pamphlets. They're passing out pamphlets. They're doing whatever they want to do. And what are we doing? We're fighting amongst ourselves here.
Yeah, well,
Luger and Sting are fighting. Savage doesn't like Flair. Flair and Arn are getting along with, they don't get along with the Dungeon of Doom. Benoit and Sullivan don't get along. I mean, how are we going to beat a bunch of people that get along with money and a plan when we have a lot of money, no plan, and can't get along? Simple. I'm thinking of maybe
jumping ship. I'm sure
you
are.
No, I didn't say that.
European uppercut.
did not say that. Not as long as Hogan's involved. Well, not that I'd jump anyway, but...
Yeah, of course.
I'm saying as long as Hogan's involved, I will be involved in nothing he's involved in.
Jumping spin wheel kick from Alex Wright.
Yeah, he's the one that's agile.
Yeah, yes, he is. Gonna German suplex him here. There he got it. To a Paul Nelson German suplex bridge. Got the shoulders down.
Oh,
one,
look
two,
at that.
Three.
That's a good call, and I'll tell you why in a moment. That's a good call on Nick Patrick's part.
You're taking it for Nick Patrick now.
I'll show you why, and you'll have to agree with me on this one.
All right, Brain, why don't you take it away?
I'll be glad to.
And show us
all to watch very careful.
Show us why here.
Okay.
You're taking it for Nick Patrick. You're on the take.
No, I'm not. Look at this. Opponent goes up in the air to Hammond Egger, lands on the back of his back. Only part of your back you can land on. Alex Wright, spin wheel kick, levels him. Now watch Nick Patrick very closely. And watch the shoulders of this man who's being pinned. German suplex. Patrick goes into position. You notice the man's shoulders up. Patrick stops the count. He doesn't count until he notices all shoulders are down. Thank you very much. Your turn, Judge Ito.
Welcome, fans, to the Halloween Havoc Control Center. This is Tony Schiavone as we head to our next pay-per-view spectacular, and this, fans, is the big one. Slim Jim presents WCW's Halloween Havoc live from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, Sunday, October 27th, at a very special starting time of 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 on the West Coast. Call your local cable operator right now for availability. Satellite dish owners call Turner Premier or DirecTV. What a setting this will be for the most anticipated world title bout in many years. The heavyweight champion of the world, Hollywood Hulk Hogan, will defend the belt against the Macho Man, Randy Savage. And I don't have to tell you the importance of this match. Hogan won the title back in August at our Hog Wild pay-per-view. And since that time, he has defaced the title belt itself and has claimed it to be the NWO's championship, not WCW. In other action, just announced, the WCW Cruiserweight title will be on the line as champion Rey Mysterio Jr. meets former champ Dean Malenko. Plus, a match for the Battle Bowl championship ring will be on the line. Diamond Dallas collides with the rightful owner of that ring, Eddie Guerrero. In addition, be sure to enter the Slim Jim Snap to Win sweepstakes, where you can win a road-legal Slim Jim monster truck, a trip for four to the Slim Jim Halloween Havoc, live at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas on October 27th, or other great prizes. For official rules, see in-store displays or send a self-addressed stamped envelope to the address on your screen. No purchase necessary. Sweepstakes open to continental U.S. residents. All entries must be received by October 23rd, 1996. Fans, make your plans to join us exclusively on pay-per-view. Satellite dish owners call Turner Premier, 1-800-843-9266, or DirecTV, 1-800-347-3288. We'll have more next week. Slim Jim presents WCW's Halloween Havoc, live from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas.
Worldwide Wrestling, Slim Jims presents Halloween Havoc. Good to have you with us. We know you're going to be with us at the entertainment capital of the world. WCW is, and you can check out the records. Number one in wrestling all around the world. We prove it each and every week on Monday night on Nitro. We prove it each and every week right here. This is wrestling's number one syndicated television program, Worldwide Wrestling.
And you are also looking at the number one tag team in professional wrestling, one half. That is CB Ray, and he's taking on a very, very tough man who will not take a back step to anybody. Not a real bright guy, Rick Steiner.
Doesn't need to be. Rick Steiner made a comment the day before Fall Brawl took the air a couple of weeks ago, and he said, you know, we, being he and his brother Scott, want a shot at the World Tag Team Championship. And we want the winner of Fall Brawl. Well, thanks to Colonel Parker and Sister Sherry, they wanted Fall Brawl. Now, you may be asking me, Brain. You may not be, but you may be asking me, where's Colonel, where's Sherry right now?
Okay, I'll bite. Where's Colonel and where's Sherry right now?
There, ringside. Got you, didn't I?
Once in a while, you have to do this to him. It's like scratching a dog behind the ear.
Okay.
It makes his foot thump.
All right. Actually, Sister Sherry is out there by herself. There is no Colonel Parker. I understand Colonel Parker has been on a extended shopping spree.
Oh.
He is getting ready to go back to Vegas. Last time they were in Vegas, it was not a pretty sight. There was a marriage that went awry. But when they show up at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc, he's trying to win back her love in the city he lost it in.
Let me put it to you this way. You may see on her left hand, third finger, a ring that you're going to think's a Brunswick bowling ball that shines. He may buy her something that big.
He may buy her a bowling ball, knowing him.
Can you see the bridal suite at the MGM?
Wow. Wow, great. Meanwhile, in the ring, keep in mind now, Scott Steiner has not come out with his brother, but Booker T is out with Stevie Ray, so Rick Steiner has his back literally up against the wall here. And now Rick Steiner pounding away, sending the man in. Whoa. Back elbow.
You know, this must be very hard for both these men in that ring right now because they're so used to tag team wrestling. They're used to looking in the corner, seeing where their brother is, seeing how far you are to make that tag. Now you're in there on your own. You got to depend on your own skills.
Out to the floor. The dog face gremlin.
Well, why does that man bark? I mean, dogs don't yell. Why does that man bark? He's not a... Does he have a mind of a chihuahua?
He may have, I don't know, but I know he's got the ability of a champion in the ring. And Rick Steiner, and now here's what we expected, Booker T on the other side.
You know, he's got a white shoe on and a red shoe.
Yes, he does.
And he probably thinks he has a pair of homes just like him.
And he does.
Well, those are Scott's, his brothers.
Randy Eller, the referee, checks in. Stevie Ray will shoot him to the far side. It's a big clothesline. And Rick Steiner is down. Rick Steiner literally outnumbered. Same way the Nasty Boys were outnumbered at Fall Brawl.
That's their fault.
Oh,
they knew
fault.
Going to the ring, Harlem Heat would have the Colonel and Sherry there.
Yeah, so what they have to do, what you got to do is take care of Colonel Parker first, get rid of him, get rid of Sister Sherry, make it a level playing field, and then go for it.
Exactly right, but they didn't do it, did they?
Nope.
They're dumb. Look at that lovely outfit the Colonel bought Sherry.
That's gorgeous, isn't it?
Well, there's an eye for it.
Maybe your eye, not mine.
Pull back. Rip those earmuffs off him.
You can't help him now.
No, no one can help him. He's out here by himself.
Look at the arms on Stevie Ray.
Yeah, you, Stevie Ray, you have plenty of help. Look at the fans, if you will, jammed into the Worldwide Arena. It is the hottest ticket at the MGM Studios. And it's great to have you with us as we head into Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc on Sunday, October 27th. Here's the whip in. Steiner hits the turnbuckle. Anticipation, German suplex.
Oh, and he's a big man, Stevie Ray.
Release the suplex. Clothesline him down. One, two. Stevie Ray got out of that one. Sherry and Booker T almost got in. And now Booker T is in.
Right to the chops.
He paid for it. Rolled up. One, two, three. Rick Steiner beats the odds. Beats Stevie Ray. Wins. And now...
He beat Stevie Ray. He beat the odds. And now he's getting the beat out of him right now.
Both members of Harlem Heat putting Rick Steiner down. And now...
Uh-oh.
It's the Heat Bomb.
Well... There's your winner, Rick Steiner, Lane. He's the one flat on his back, may I add.
And we'll have more Worldwide Wrestling from Disney MGM after this. There's going to be more said about this, I can tell you that, Brain.
Huh.